Whether you're moving, renovating, or updating, our designers will help your vision become a reality. Visit Ken Michaels Furniture in Brookfield on Capitol Drive and in Greenfield on Highway 100 to save 30 to 35% store-wide today. Sleep better and save more with mattresses from Milwaukee Mattress and Ken Michaels Furniture. Handcrafted in our Milwaukee factory, our mattresses utilize natural materials like cotton cushioning, which dissipates body heat, Joma wool quilts for warm wintry nights and cool summer evenings, and natural latex providing superior conformability and pressure relief for aching joints. Stop in today at any Ken Michaels Furniture store and save up to 50% compared to national brands.
Hey, WTMJ's John Mercier here. I've got a great trip coming up this Christmas. I want you to be with us. It's Magical Christmas Markets. 5 nights in Innsbruck, the capital of the Alps. We'll take in a horse-drawn carriage ride, make traditional strudel, and spend lots of time shopping in beautiful, historic Christmas markets throughout Europe. It is going to be special hunting for those treasures. I've got a beautiful brochure. I'll send it to you. Shoot me an email, john.mercure at WTMJ.com. John.mercure, M-E-R-C-U-R-E at WTMJ.com. Magical Christmas Markets. This December, won't you come with us?
Don't pay retail for your diamond engagement ring or gift. Come to cleanorigin.com.
Get started with your no-hassle refi checkup by clicking on the blue button at acunet.com.
1-0, high fly ball, right center field. Racing back is Fairchild. Back is Thompson at the wall. He reaches up, and it is gone. Bryce Terang.
The Brewers continue their series against the Reds in Cincinnati. Our coverage of the series continues tonight at 5:05 on your home of the Milwaukee Brewers. News Radio 620, WTMJ, Milwaukee.
It's 3 o'clock. I'm John Mercier. This is Wisconsin's Afternoon News. Your top story, an officer-involved shooting in Waukesha.
I'm Julia Fellow. Updates on a deadly house fire.
I'm Debbie Lozaga. Starting off with some delays southbound on 43 from about Hampton all the way down past Capitol Drive. Northbound slow from Fond du Lac up to Keith already. Westbound 94, backups out of the Marquette interchange through the stadium. And on the eastbound side, right about on the ramp to 175 northbound in the stadium, we've got a broken down vehicle on the left shoulder, kind of in a weird spot. And then, of course, we've got our backups out of the Mitchell interchange heading out towards Forest Home on 894 westbound with that construction. I'm Debbie Lozaga with your WTMJ Johnson & Sons Paving Time Saver Traffic.
Tonight, partly cloudy, a low of 44 degrees. Tomorrow, increasing clouds, mild, a high of 65 inland, a little cooler along the lake. It's currently 61 degrees. From the WTMJ Breaking News Center, Waukesha police shot and killed a man wanted for attempted vehicle theft at the CarMax on Blue Mound Road this morning. Police Chief Daniel Thompson says a foot pursuit ensued and the suspect made overt actions that were consistent with an individual drawing a firearm. A preliminary investigation determined the suspect did not have a gun. Four officers are on administrative leave while Milwaukee police lead the investigation.
A father remembers his six-year-old son who died in a fire at 36 and Roar Avenue last week.
Wilson III was pronounced dead at the hospital 4 days after a late-night house fire on April 2nd. TMJ4's Marion McCarr shares what his heartbroken father, Rashawn Wilson II, said in a text.
My son is greatly missed and my family is broken behind the loss of my special boy, and all my family want is the truth.
A neighbor in the area says,
stunned, super shocked, super sad. Like, it's, to me, that's so tragic that that happened to him. Like I said, it seemed like he didn't even get a chance.
Julian Johnson, WTMJ News.
Investigators have not yet released the cause of that fire.
A developing story in Brookfield. Police have evacuated Brookfield Elementary after a reported bomb threat against the school. Brookfield police detectives say it appears to have been a swatting incident. A search is currently being conducted at the school. Brookfield Road between North Avenue and River Road is closed until further notice.
An update to a case we've been following on WTMJ. Prosecutors say they need more time to consider charges for a man considered to be a person of interest in the investigation of a leg that was found in Cudahy exactly 1 week ago at Warnemont Park. Today, the Milwaukee Journal Sentinel says prosecutors asked a court commissioner to keep the man in custody for another 72 hours while they consider charges. Police have not said who they believe the leg belongs to or if the case is connected to other human remains found in Milwaukee over this weekend.
Governor Evers signing into law the PRINCE Act, aiming to broaden approval for missing children alerts in Wisconsin.
With the governor's signature today, the PRINCE Act becomes the Purple Alert. State Senator LaTanya Johnson was critical in the implementation of the act and tells WTMJ,
"We were cognitive of making sure that this alert applied to children 10 and under and then 18 and under for children with physical or cognitive disabilities that would prevent them from returning home safely."
Governor Evers added he expects the alert to be implemented within the coming weeks. In Milwaukee, Adam Roberts, WTMJ News.
Arizona Supreme Court says a 160-year-old law is the law of the land when it comes to banning abortion. ABC's Alex Stone.
It was for many years a dormant and forgotten about law written in 1864 before Arizona was a state and the country was in the midst of the Civil War. The law banned abortion except to save a mother's life. Now Arizona's Supreme Court says that ancient law is the law in Arizona, not a newer version that banned abortion after 15 weeks. Arizona Governor Katie Hobbs is calling on state lawmakers to repeal the 160-year-old law.
Arizona women should never have to fear the next court decision.
Stone, ABC News.
Coming up, a military upgrade for the Wisconsin National Guard.
Setting unlimited WTMJ News Time, 3:04.
Associated Bank knows your small business isn't just a venture. It's your dream and a vital part of the community. And we're not just a bank. We're your neighbors. We're looking out for you. That's why Associated Bank offers quick online applications and approvals with funding in as fast as one business day, checking with no minimum balances or maintenance fees, and prompt customer service. Explore our products at associatedbank.com/business or visit a branch for more details. Subject to credit approval. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Guthrie and Fry Water Conditioning. Better water makes a big difference. It's Guthrie and Fry. I know. I have their stuff in my house. The water softener. They bring the salt to my house. I've got an RO system. That means that the water coming into my house that we drink, that we cook with, is crisp, clean, clear. Guthrie and Fry makes sure I've got the best water in the neighborhood. They offer friendly, convenient, budget-conscious solutions. GuthrieFryWater.com. Rob and Sue, the owners, they are top-notch. And when their people are in your house, it's going to be like having family in your house. Quality products and services at a fair price from a local company you can trust. It's Guthrie and Fry Water Conditioning. In-house plumbers that can handle the tough questions. They don't need to come back. They handle it on the first trip. It's Guthrie and Fry Water Conditioning.
We asked people why they sold their homes to Grandview Homes instead of using a real estate agent.
Everything they say in their ads is true and then some. Very fair price, no real estate agent fees or closing costs. They even switched the utilities out of your name.
Within weeks, we had closed and couldn't be happier.
Whether you have a hard-to-sell home, want a stress-free sale, or simply need to sell your home fast, Grandview Homes is the name you know and the name you can trust. Visit GrandviewHomes.com to discover the easiest and fastest way to sell a home.
From the biggest plays on the court to the comments made in the locker room after, an in-depth recap of every Bucks game in 6 minutes. No more, no less. Bucks in Six provides game recaps for every game. Hear the high-flying dunks from Giannis.
Puts it on the floor, spins down the lane, and plunges it through.
Or the deep threes from Dame.
Dame time has arrived with 107.
Bucks in Six on the Bucks Plus Audio Network. Find it now on Bucks.com/plus or on Spotify, Apple, and wherever you get your podcasts.
Citing Unlimited WTMJ News Time, 3:07.
It could be a big boost for a military installation at Milwaukee's Mitchell International Airport.
Wisconsin National Guard's 128th Air Refueling Wing is among 15 bases in the U.S. that may be getting new aircraft. 128th announced the wing is being considered as a future home for the KC-46A Pegasus, a considerable upgrade to the refueling tankers in the current fleet. Tankers are designed to refuel fighter jets and other aircraft midair. The 128th has been deployed in missions around the world, boasting more than 1,600 jobs here in southeast Wisconsin. Vince Vetrano, WTMJ News.
Time for a WTMJ sports update from the Gruber Law Office's One Call, That's All Sports Desk. After a wild 10-8 loss to the Reds last night, the Brewers try again tonight in Cincinnati. Coverage begins at 5:05 on WTMJ. The Bucks aim to snap a four-game losing streak tonight against the Eastern Conference-leading Boston Celtics. You can hear the game on 94.5 ESPN at 6:30. Four games left in the regular season for the Bucks, and they're currently one game ahead of the Magic and the Knicks for second place in the Eastern Conference playoff race.
Setting Unlimited WTMJ News Time, 3:08.
Tax tips are brought to you by the Neal Group. For less stress with the IRS, visit nealgroup.net. That's NEAL group.net for a free consultation.
Hi, this is Michelle Voskel, CPA and team member at the Neal Group, with a tip from Tucker the Tax Dog. There are 5 filing statuses you can use when preparing your return: single, married filing jointly, married filing separately, head of household, and qualifying surviving spouse. Filing status is determined on December 31st of the tax filing year. Each case should be examined to determine the most appropriate status within the tax law. Often, couples in the middle of a divorce believe that they should file 2 returns, but that is not always the case. If the divorce is not final on December 31st, you are still considered married. But there may be a situation where married filing separately makes sense, even if filing jointly gives a lower tax amount. Head of household can be a confusing status. 2 unmarried adults living in the same home may each be able to claim head of household on their returns in certain circumstances. Tax preparers will get the best results for you when asking all of the right questions. For more information on this tip and other tax tips, go to nealgroup.net or stop in and see us. Tucker loves to get treats.
Wisconsin's Afternoon News is on the air, broadcasting live from the Annex Wealth Management Studios at The Avenue in beautiful downtown Milwaukee. Here are your hosts, John McCure and Julia Fellow.
Hey, happy Tuesday, Julia.
Here we are.
We're glad that you're with us out there, too, driving around, whatever you're doing. Thanks for checking us out. You can always watch the show, too. We have state-of-the-art cameras in here. You can watch live on the YouTube channel or through the website. There's a little button you hit, boom, watch live, and you can check us out. All right, some things that we're tracking on this Tuesday.
This is the 3 at 3 on Wisconsin's Afternoon News.
Where do we start?
El Salvador offering free passports for people to move there.
This is so interesting. They say they don't have enough skilled workers in areas like science, medicine, engineering, philosophers, and artists. And so the president of the country is a very controversial figure. Says, I'm going to give 5,000 free passports to highly skilled workers. You'll be able to come and move here. You'll be able to vote. You'll be able to have all the benefits of someone who was born in El Salvador. If you're one of these occupations, you'll be granted full citizen status. He's been trying to upgrade the population there, and he says, I may need to look outside the borders. This guy's very controversial. He was praised because he cracked down on crime in the country. Well, it ends up that lots of people are in jail that probably shouldn't be, and they're being tortured and abused. It's very, very controversial, this president. So we'll see what happens with Nayib Bukele's plan. That's the name of the president. All right, what's next?
Wow. Unusual age group leaving TikTok, possibly.
This surprised me. So the 20-somethings, according to new survey research, are walking away from TikTok. So TikTok use among the youngest generation is down 10% in the last year. So what is that? Gen Z, I think, is the young generation up until like the late 20s. Mm-hmm. Down 10% in the last year. Other populations are down 32%. So experts are trying to figure out if it's because of all the bad press about China and TikTok, or if it's because there's burnout and fatigue and people are just tired. I don't use it as much as I use Twitter or Facebook, but I do like to scroll through it and see pet videos and home improvement stuff. And
it's so addicting.
And it's funny.
Oh my gosh, it's so addicting. And it goes to your algorithm. And then it's like, yeah, America's Funniest Home Videos, at least what I'm seeing.
Yeah, and then you're right. It goes to the algorithm. Then it feeds you even more what you want. So
right,
you're just, you look up and it's like, my gosh, I've been on my phone for an hour looking at TikTok.
That was me last night.
Yeah, so it's dropping off though, apparently. And what's the third thing?
Dating apps are out.
And what's in is speed dating. Speed dating's very old. This is the kind of thing where in the old days you would show up at a bar or a restaurant and there would be 30 men and 30 women, and you sit down at a table across from somebody and you literally have a couple of minutes to ask each other questions and then decide if you want to continue to date. Well, speed dating is back, and it's back with the younger generation. Experts say that the youngest generation, once again Z primarily, is tired of dating apps, that they're getting burned out. People have fake stuff on there.
Right.
And so speed dating is coming back, and there are big organizations. Eventbrite is one. You're probably familiar with that. They run a lot of charity events. Eventbrite now is running speed dating across the country. They say speed dating events are up 63% in the last year. They're up big time, and people want to meet other people in person, according to their research. So dating apps, make no mistake about it, they're still a thing. They're still being used, but they're on the decline a little bit, and speed dating is gaining traction.
Oh, thank goodness I didn't have to do that with my husband, all those apps. I met him in 2008 before any of that was going on. Thank goodness.
Check this out, too. This is a new thing with speed dating. especially young women, are doing it in groups. So, like, you get three or four girlfriends and you go to a speed dating site and you all do the speed dating, but you go as a kind of a group.
Oh, I love that.
Yeah, kind of like a girls' night out. And maybe you leave with a date.
Or you fight with each other.
Yeah, exactly. I wanted that guy. Table yeah. number seven. Did you like table number seven? Yeah, me too. Coming up next, we're going to check out what's going on in Israel. There's a major development today. Could it be that Israel is getting ready to go into Rafah? That's where most of the refugees are. That's where most people who have escaped the violence are. What happens next? How do Israelis feel about all that? And is there more aid finally on the way? Jordana Miller live with us from Israel after Debbie helps get you home.
He asked,
if I could be a host on WTMJ's Wisconsin's Morning News, I think that would really be the pinnacle of my career.
So we answered. Jeff Levering is our Brewers 360 guest every Wednesday at 7:45.
I don't know how I could call a game without the suggestions I get from Eric and Vince.
So in Arizona, you could drop a, I was in the pool, if the ball lands in the little pool.
Oh, outstanding.
If they hit a home run. So there you go. You're welcome.
On Wisconsin's Morning News, sponsored by Outdoor Living Unlimited and Holiday Automotive.
Hey, John Mercier here for my friends at Dave Drag Camp Heating. They've been coming to my house for more than a decade, and on every level, too. They installed a new system in my house a few years back. They come out for routine maintenance. Dave Drag Camp's been there when I've had an issue in the middle of the night, and they've taken care of it. They live in Wisconsin. They understand the crazy climate, the temperature swings, the precipitation, all of that stuff, because they've been here. For more than 40 years, Dave Drag Camp has been our neighbor, and their comfort is your importance. They love to make sure you are taken care of. They're ready for anything because they know Wisconsin. Spring, summer, fall, or winter, even when they all seem to happen at once, whatever you're experiencing, whether it's a home comfort dilemma, you need new equipment, or you need routine maintenance, Dave Drag Camp Heating will take care of you. They've been taking care of us for a very long time. Got a question? Need some advice? Need a new system? The teams I trust for heating and AC are at Dave Drag Camp Heating. Their tradition is your comfort. DaveDragCamp.com. Google it. Just check it out. DaveDragCamp.com.
Hi, I'm attorney David Gruber. After an accident, you need a trusted winning team on your side. For more than 30 years, Gruber Law Offices has helped Wisconsin families get the results they deserve. If you've been injured, call our firm today for a free consultation. We're available 24/7. Wisconsin's own Gruber Law Offices, proud partner of your Milwaukee Brewers. One call, that's all.
Traffic is sponsored by the Wisconsin State Fair. Wisconsin State Fair has $12 group tickets on sale now. Hurry, the sale ends April 30th. Visit wistatefair.com to save big for group tickets.
Traffic and weather begins with Debbie Lozaga. How are we doing out there, Deb?
Well, we got a little bit of an issue. Westbound 94 right about at St. Paul Avenue. The center lane is blocked with a crash. So that's going to start to back things up into the Marquette pretty substantially. So be careful with that. Northbound on 43 is slow from about Kilbourne all the way up to Keefe. Southbound's heavy from Hampton down to Keefe. Then we've also got backups along southbound 894 from about Oklahoma Avenue down and around the Hale interchange to about 84th Street. Westbound's backed up out of the Mitchell all the way to 68th Street. Hey, BRI's on the roads. Report accidents, slowdowns, and road conditions to the WTMJ Hall Volkswagen traffic tip line at 414-238-9329. I'm Debbie Lozaga with your WTMJ Johnson & Sons Paving Time Saver Traffic.
The WTMJ 5-day forecast. Tonight, partly cloudy, a low of 44 degrees. Tomorrow, increasing clouds, mild, high of 65. On Thursday, windy, rainy, a high of 50. On Friday, partly cloudy, a high of 53. On Saturday, mostly sunny, a high of 60 degrees. In Milwaukee, right now, it's 62 degrees. Wanted to bring you the latest on what's happening in Israel. A couple major developments this afternoon. Jordana Miller is with us from Jerusalem this afternoon. I guess I want to start, Jordana, with any update you can give us on when Israel may go into Rafah.
Well, despite the Israeli Prime Minister saying there's a date to go into Rafah, according to according to the Secretary of State Antony Blinken, the U.S. has not been given any date. And there's even leaked reports from the Israeli Defense Minister's office that even in his conversation with Defense Minister Lloyd Austin, there was no date given for the Rafah operation. You know, it has to be understood that Netanyahu, by saying there's a date for Rafah, he was trying and, you know, he was really trying to appease his far right coalition, who's very angry and threatening to pull out of the government and bring down the government because Netanyahu pulled all of Israel's troops out of southern Gaza on Sunday, the 6-month anniversary of the war, leaving just a few thousand troops in the Strip. And, you know, they're fuming because they believe the prime minister has ended the war before reaching its aims, before fully pushing Hamas out. And, you know, somehow in their minds, it looks like Netanyahu's forfeiting Rafah, right? So Netanyahu had to come out and say, no, we're going into Rafah, we have a date. But it doesn't seem there really is a date. And it has to be said that it will take many, many weeks before Israel can go in and carry out any major assault on Hamas and Rafah. That's because Israel now has to bring troops back in. They also have to spend several weeks evacuating civilians from the south to the center of the country. And none of that's going to happen overnight. So, you know, here the estimate is that any Rafah operation is likely 6 weeks away, 2 months away. And right now there's a window open for the ceasefire talks. So it's even delayed. You know, we have to see what happens in the next couple of weeks with that.
ABC's Jordana Miller. Jordana, can you talk more about that? Hamas is reviewing that latest ceasefire proposal from the U.S.
That's right. You know, Hamas initially saying that, you know, that Israel hasn't really met their demands, but they're still going to study the proposal. You know, I think we're really going to have to wait and see in these next couple days whether Hamas is serious about a deal or not. They scuttled the last deal. They seem to be in no rush to close a deal. And, you know, more than one analyst here has pointed out that Hamas is actually in a strong position, even though there's vast destruction in the Gaza Strip, and they've been, a lot of their battalions have been defeated, and their fighters have been killed. Hamas leaders, the top leadership, are still alive. They're still holding 129 hostages. More aid than ever is getting into the Gaza Strip, something they need. And they see there's daylight between Israel and the United States, which makes them happy, and that the United States doesn't want Israel to go into Rafah. So time is kind of on their side. They want an absolute end to the war, and Israel, of course, is refusing to grant that right now because, you know, they haven't fulfilled their goals. Hamas has not been pushed out of the Gaza Strip. And we have to understand, Hamas is trying to stay in control. They're trying to stay in power in Gaza and survive after this war. I mean, for Israel and the United States, that's a non-starter. But that's what they're trying to do, and they're using the hostages and the world's plummeting, or I should say, you know, the world's growing anger with Israel over the humanitarian aid issue and the civilian deaths. That all works into Hamas's playbook.
Jordan, I wanted to ask you, when we talked to you early on in the war, we could sometimes literally hear sirens and missiles and things in the background when you were on the phone with us. A lot of time has now passed. What is it like day to day when you talk to people in your neighborhood, when you're with others with families? What is it like for the average Israeli this far into the war and how you all are feeling about things?
Well, I think, you know, people are exhausted from the war. You know, it's everywhere. It's all the time. And the issue with the hostages, it's like a festering wound here that is, you know, it's, you know, it feels like the country's in pain all the time, you know, and until those hostages come out, you know, Israel won't really be able to heal from what happened on October 7th, nor I think will Israel be able to really assess what its next move is, you know, militarily or strategically vis-a-vis Gaza. So it's not easy. And right now, things are tense because, you know, everyone is waiting for Iran to respond to the Israeli assassination of one of their top generals in Damascus a little more than a week ago. And that response is expected to come in the next several days. And so I think people are a little nervous about that. You know, will Iran, you know, fire directly on Israel? Will they fire along with Hezbollah and the Houthis and the Iraqis and the Syrians? I mean, you know, are we going to see a swarm of ballistic missiles and drones, you know, come, you know, descend on Israel? It's a little scary, but Israel says that it's working with the United States and its allies, you know, and that its air force and defenses are, you know, ready for whatever happens. So that's, while things seem a little quieter in Gaza, now, you know, what's going to happen with Iran is kind of front and center.
ABC's Jordana Miller in Jerusalem. Jordana, thank you.
Thank you.
It is 324 at WTMJ.
Do you have questions about how you can preserve and protect your hard-earned assets? Hi, I'm Jeff Kowal, founder of Kowal Investment Group, the retirement specialist. Join us on Thursday, April 25th at Revere's in Delafield, that's in Lake Country, as we discuss how you can keep family wealth in the family. Whether you are preparing to retire or already retired, it's our mission to help you get the information you need to make the best decisions for you and your loved ones. That's why we've teamed with industry experts and our trusted partners, John Koenig. He's an estate planner and attorney with Elder Advisors Law, and Chris Behrens, a trust officer and vice president of Horicon Bank, to bring you the latest information on estate planning, wills, trusts, and more, especially for those with $1 million or more in assets. This is a free event, but you do need to register and space is limited. Visit the events page at thecoalway.com for details and to reserve your seat, or give our office a call at 262-522-4040. It's 262-522-4040.
Kowal Investment Group is a registered investment advisor.
Sit means sit dog training. So yesterday, Michelle came home. She had been out of town for a few days. And the dogs were so excited to see her that, of course, when she walked in the door, and this is natural, they jumped on her and they were barking and jumping and jumping and jumping. Well, I wanted to jump on her, too, because I hadn't seen her in a long time. And, well, that sounded weird, didn't it? So I was like, Bella Baxter, get down. And they did. They listened, thanks to Sit Mean Sit Dog Training. Then Michelle was probably like, John, get down. But Sit Mean Sit Dog Training actually has put our dogs in a much better place. They listen better. They're not as barky. They're not as jumpy. They're happy and confident. It's Sit Mean Sit Dog Training. Schedule a free consultation. That's how we started years ago. It's Sit Mean Sit Dog Training. They'll take care of you big time.
For your next night out, make Aria, the acclaimed restaurant inside St. Kate the Arts Hotel, your dinner destination. Aria, nestled on the second floor of St. Kate, is an artful dining experience that captivates with its culinary creativity. Delighting in its offering of artisanal American cuisine, the restaurant transcends tradition and leans into the realm of playful and inventive flavors. Come and experience the magic of Aria, where every bite is a work of culinary artistry. Learn more and make reservations at aria@stkate.com.
The Mr. Fix-It Show this Saturday is sponsored by Aaron's. When purchasing lawn equipment from Olson's Outdoor Power Equipment, you're well taken care of after the sale. Olson's knowledgeable staff handles the warranty and parts, can answer all of your questions, and can handle all your tune-ups and repairs. Check out the impressive line of lawnmowers on display at Olson's Outdoor Power Equipment Showroom in Muskego. Stop in and say hi to Fawn, the guest this Saturday on The Fix-It Show, sponsored by Aaron's. That's Olson's Outdoor Power Equipment in Muskego, sponsored by Aaron's.
CertaPro Painters know how important your home is to you. I know how good a job they do because CertaPro Painters did our house. WTMJ's John Mercure here. It was professional, it was easy, it was quick, and it was efficient. And so affordable. It's CertaPro Painters. They get the job done right, even those hard-to-reach places they will knock out of the ballpark. Free estimates, reliable communication, professional painting, all at the right price. When choosing a painting professional, the choice is simple. Choose happy. Choose CertaPro Painters. Choose the team we went with, CertaPro Painters. Time for the WTMJ Annex Wealth Management Market Update. Kind of a weird day. Everything was in the red for most of the day. Then the S&P ended up 8 points on the day. The NASDAQ ended up 53 points on the day. And the Dow almost got back to even. It was down 9 points on the day. Annex Wealth Management, it's a great time for your retirement and investment strategy review from a fee-only fiduciary. That's Annex. Go to annexwealth.com. Click the Get Started button today.
Good news, bad news. The good news, inflation today is nothing like it's been in the past few years. The bad news, lower inflation doesn't mean lower prices. Inflation only records the size of price increases. When it goes down, prices are still higher than they were before. In fact, a recent study showed investors still consider inflation their single biggest threat to their investment and retirement plans. We don't blame you if you're concerned about how inflation might affect your legacy, your financial freedom, or your confidence. It's time to meet with the team at Annex Wealth Management for investment, retirement, tax, and estate planning. Annex is a fee-only fiduciary. We'll review what you own. We'll work together to build a plan that's right for you and your family. And we'll guide you on your way to achieving the kind of retirement you desire. Whatever's kickstarting your questions, market volatility, global unrest, an upcoming presidential election, or stubborn inflation, it's time to know the difference. Financial planning at every level. Annex Comprehensive Wealth, Annex Private Client, Annex Ignite. Click the Get Started button at annexwealth.com.
Hey, I've got a cool trip coming up. John Mercure here. I'd love for you to be with us. I'm taking listeners to the magical Christmas markets of Europe. This is going to be so cool. It's the first week in December. It's December 6th through the 13th. What an itinerary. 5 nights in Innsbruck, nestled in the amazing Alps, right there in the Harz. Medieval Christmas markets in towns in places like Salzburg and Munich. A train ride to an Alpine village. We'll make and eat traditional strudel, the oldest restaurant in Europe. We'll check that out as well. And it's Christmas markets all the way around. I've got a great brochure. Send me an email. I send you the brochure. John.Mercure@WTMJ.com. John.Mercure, M-E-R-C-U-R-E @WTMJ.com. Lots of hot chocolate, mulled wine, great food, Christmas shopping in the Alps. This is so cool. I'm really jazzed. I'd love for you to be with us. Send me an email. I'll get you all the information, including pricing. John.Mercure, M-E-R-C-U-R-E @WTMJ.com.
My house has a new glow. I love my windows. Universal Windows Direct.
Hey, it's WTMJ's Steve Scafidi. Right now, schedule your free in-home estimate, and for every two windows you buy, get the next two free. Plus, a free upgrade to triple pane glass, and they'll double your energy tax credit. Restrictions apply. Just like me, you'll be saying,
I love my windows. They've got that brand new home effect. So Windows Direct.
Wisconsin's afternoon news on Wisconsin's radio station, News Radio WTMJ.
It's 3:31. I'm John Mercure. Your top story updates on a bomb threat in Brookfield.
I'm Julia Fellow. A deadly stabbing this morning.
I'm Debbie Lazago. We got some problems in Ozaukee County on Mequon Road. Both directions of Mequon Road is closed right now at Cedarburg Road. This is right near, well, it's basically Highway 57. So watch out for that whole area. Try and avoid it if you can. The other issue is on 894 southbound at Oklahoma Avenue. We've got a crash that has the two right lanes blocked. So that's going to be affecting your ride coming out of the Greenfield Avenue area at the moment. It's going to get worse, though. Westbound 94 leaving the mark. Cat going to be heavy all the way through the stadium. Eastbound is slow from about 84th Street through the stadium to about 27th Street. And while you're out navigating the roads as quickly and safely as possible, if you happen to see something we should know about, call us at the WTMJ Hall Volkswagen Traffic Tip Line at 414-238-9329. I'm Debbie Lazago with your WTMJ Johnson & Sons Paving Time Saver Traffic.
Tonight, it will be cloudy with a low of 44. Tomorrow, mild. The high will be 62 at the lake, 65 inland. It's 61 degrees right now in Milwaukee.
From the WTMJ Breaking News Center, police say Brookfield Elementary is safe after a bomb threat was called in there. Students and staff are evacuated just after noon and have since returned to school. Students will be released coming up here shortly at the end of the school day. City of Brookfield police are still investigating the origin of the bomb threat and working to identify a suspect.
A 75-year-old stabbed to death in Milwaukee early this morning. Milwaukee police investigating this as a domestic violence-related stabbing. It happened at 89th and Adler. Police are seeking a known suspect in this case.
A 50-year-old wanted for attempted vehicle theft at the CarMax in Waukesha, dead after officers shot him.
The suspect was transferred to an area hospital for advanced care, where it's later pronounced deceased.
Police Chief Daniel Thompson says the suspect, quote, made overt actions that are consistent with an individual drawing a firearm, though a preliminary investigation determined the suspect did not have a gun.
The officers acted within state statutes and fulfilled the mission of the Waukesha Police Department, which is a pledge to serve with integrity, honor, and courage.
Four officers have been placed on leave. Milwaukee police will lead the investigation. Adam Roberts, WTMJ News.
An update to a case we've been following on WTMJ. Prosecutors say they need more time to consider charges for a man considered to be a person of interest in the investigation of a leg, severed leg, found in Cudahy exactly 1 week ago in Warnemont Park. Today, the Milwaukee Journal Sentinel says the prosecutors asked a court commissioner to keep the man in custody another 72 hours while they consider charges. Police have not said who the leg belongs to, but in court today, they did connect it to other human remains found in Milwaukee over this weekend.
A popular Wisconsin comedian is coming to the Wisconsin State Fair.
Acclaimed comedian and Emmy Award winner Charlie Behrens brings his old-fashioned tour to the State Fair main stage August 8th. Behrens tells Wisconsin's Midday News.
My first tour was, you know, about the Midwest, and a lot of this tour is about a guy from the Midwest.
Behrens is in Iowa this week and recently completed tour stops in Southern California.
You're golden here in Wisconsin, but how do these shows go over when you're in L.A.? It's got to be different.
Yeah, I mean, I'm more like silver or bronze out there, you know, maybe like a high-quality lead.
Greg Matzik, WTMJ News.
Former and current Packers players making their way across the Badger State.
Former DT Mike Daniels was one of them. And at Mesmer High School on Monday, he made an effort to interact with the students as he talked about perseverance. He tells WTMJ.
When you're speaking with kids, you need them to be able to feel comfortable when they're listening to you. Notice there was a lot of chattering. Then all of a sudden it was like you could hear a pin drop as I was talking. Guys, I understand you. Guys, I've been where you're at. And I'm not talking down to you like I'm an adult. I'm talking to you like someone who understands. When you give that type of respect, then it's given back.
From Mesmer.
Time for a WTMJ sports update from the Gruber Law Office's One Call, That's All Sports Desk. After a wild 10-8 loss to the Reds last night, the Brewers will try again tonight in Game 2. Coverage begins at 5:05 on WTMJ. And the Bucks aim to snap a four-game losing streak tonight against the Eastern Conference-leading Celtics. Hear the game on 94.5 ESPN at 6:30. With four games left in the regular season, the Bucks are currently one game ahead of the Magic and the Knicks for second place in the Eastern Conference playoff race.
Setting Unlimited WTMJ News Time, 3:36.
Acunet Mortgage is an equal housing lender. NMLS ID 255368.
Steve and Ashley heard our radio ads over the years, and when it came time to buy their first home, clicked on the blue button. One of our senior loan consultants, Brad, sent them a credit-verified pre-approval the same day and then upgraded to a rock-solid, fully verified and guaranteed pre-approval shortly thereafter. They made a couple offers without success, and then Brad told them about Acunet's new property-specific pre-approval, where we might be able to include those magic words, no appraisal required. When they wrote their next offer, several thousand dollars over asking to make sure someone else didn't end up sleeping in their dream home, their property-specific rock-solid guaranteed pre-approval included that most powerful phrase, no appraisal required, and the sellers picked Steve and Ashley's offer over several others. If you think all mortgage lenders and pre-approvals are the same, think again. Go with a local mortgage lender that has the tools and know-how to help you win and save money, too. Click on the blue button today at accunet.com.
Wisconsin's Afternoon News on WTMJ.
We're doing something super cool. We're giving away $100 gift cards to Ishnala, the supper club in Lake Delton, minutes from the Wisconsin Dells. Right now, if you are caller number seven to 855-616-1620, caller number seven wins a $100 gift card to Ishnala. This is going to be a great night for you. $100 to caller number seven, 855-616-1620. We'll give away gift card every day this week. Good luck.
That's awesome. How fun.
That's fun. That's a great place.
Want to switch gears here. Governor Tony Evers, it was embargoed yesterday. We couldn't announce this. We knew it since yesterday, but just this morning, our reporter Adam Roberts was there at about 9 o'clock. He signed the PRINCE Act. It's aimed to fill gaps in missing children statewide alerts. So you may have been hearing about silver alerts. That's meant to find elderly adults who meet certain criteria. Green alerts for veterans. Within the next few weeks, Governor Tony Evers says a purple alert will be implemented, broadening missing children alerts across Wisconsin. It's after very high-profile cases, like missing 5-year-old Prince McCree in Milwaukee last year and 10-year-old Lily Peters in Chippewa Falls in 2022, where both were reported missing, then they were found dead, and neither had met the criteria for an Amber Alert, and people were outraged. Peters went to visit her aunt's house about a quarter mile from her home. Remember this case? Didn't know where she was. Her father reported her missing at 9 p.m. after Lily had not been back home. At the time, Chippewa Falls police said their hands were tied, that they needed a description of the abductor. That's what you need for an Amber Alert. And a vehicle to be on the lookout for. And this girl was just on her bicycle. So they couldn't do that. A 14-year-old boy assaulted and murdered her. She was found the next day off a bike path. And a Good Samaritan 2 years ago, Eric Henry, collected thousands of signatures, pushing lawmakers to create an entirely new alert, just like this one signed today.
Create a new alert called the Lily Alert that is sent out quicker and with less requirements and restrictions.
Also tying Prince McCree, he was found dead in a dumpster when his case did not fit the criteria for an Amber Alert. State Senator LaTanya Johnson, she lives just houses down from Prince's family and felt nothing was being done to find Prince after his disappearance, and he didn't qualify for an Amber Alert. State Senator LaTanya Johnson credits work on both sides of the aisle to get this job done and for this to be signed today.
This is an example of what should happen when we find out that there are loopholes or fragments in laws.
Now, something that I want to say with the qualifications that both of these cases did not meet an Amber Alert, they did meet a critical missing alert issued. But you can only broadcast that through TV and radio. So this bill would send out an alert within a radius of where the child went missing. It's not as expansive as an Amber Alert. So we're at the lowest to the extreme, and now we have a middle, and it will be called a purple alert. And Governor Tony Evers says that it's going to be implemented in the coming weeks.
This is a big deal, and it's something that, as you pointed out, both sides have said, we need this. Republicans and Democrats came together to pass this. When Prince McCree, I think it was October when he went missing, when that happened, and then it tragically ended— and then it was realized after the fact that the police wanted to send messages out and wanted to do things and their hands were tied. It's great the way you put this all together because it's all the voices and points out that we can come together and get things done when children are involved or when safety and security are involved. And I guess a few weeks, that's pretty quick that he signed it. And in a few weeks, it'll become the real deal.
Our state stepped up. Amber Alert, that there's way more broader qualifications to change that. So the lawmakers stepped in and they came together and we're going to find our children. It's just terrible to that this outcome happened, but that's what it's called, a purple alert.
Yeah. So Prince McCree and Lily Peters and their families behind this. It is 3:42 at WTMJ. So a high-profile case has been going on in Michigan. Oxford High School, 4 students shot and killed by a deranged guy. His parents held accountable, convicted a couple of weeks ago, and sentenced today. Could that happen here in Wisconsin? Could parents be held accountable if something really bad happened? Local criminal defense attorney Jonathan Lavoie with us after the break. On WTMJ.
It's like playing baseball in the house.
Mom! Dad broke the window.
Without the risk of...
again.
That. Every Thursday at 8:40, play virtual baseball on Wisconsin's Morning News. Step up to the virtual plate and test your mettle against the best.
Swing and a drive!
It's Virtual Baseball, presented by Siding Unlimited. Only played here on WTMJ.
Guess what? Last night I was at one of my favorite places, the Fox and Hounds. Went to the Fox and Hounds last night, took Michelle. She had been out of town. She said, man, I want to go to the Fox and Hounds. So we did. We walked in. It's beautiful. and the setting is so nice, and the food was so good. Dan was our server. Dan, the man, was incredible. It's such good food, and it's such a great deal. It's recently been voted, did you know this, Top Choice Award winner for fine dining and most romantic restaurant. Best Sunday brunch. Yeah, they won that award, too. So in the Fox and Hounds last night, I had a big crock of French onion soup and a Caesar salad, like a dinner-sized Caesar salad with grilled chicken on it. Michelle had a salmon salad. Absolutely incredible. All right, I had a couple of Guinness, too. Fresh tapped Guinness, which they have on tap there. It's the real deal. And if you buy one dinner, you get one free at the Fox and Hounds. So it's the great food. It's the Dan service. And it's buy one, get one free. Incredible. Including prime rib on Wednesday. So you go tomorrow, you buy one big prime rib dinner with all the sides, you get a second prime rib dinner for free. And desserts. Oh, my gosh, desserts. They're also buy one, get one free. So celebrate a birthday, anniversary, or a quiet dinner with your sweetie, and your second dinner is always free. Easy to get there. The drive is part of the cool part, actually. It's staying light later now. So take that drive. It's off Highway 167, 2 miles east of Holy Hill. It's a beautiful drive. Reserve at foxandhoundsrestaurant.com. Mother's Day is coming up, and I asked last night how they're looking for Mother's Day. It's beginning to fill up. If you want to get to the Fox and Hounds for Mother's Day, you need to make that reservation now. It's the famous Fox and Hounds.
Hey, it's WTMJ's Steve Scafidi for the Bath Authority. If your bath or shower is old, outdated, has mold and mildew, broken tiles, you got to call my friends at the Bath Authority. The Bath Authority provides the highest quality bathroom remodeling products along with a world-class customer experience. Their modern durable tubs and showers are designed with an exclusive high-tech polymer liner. What that means to you? Low maintenance, resistance to mold and mildew, easy to clean, and lasts for decades. You're their priority at the Bath Authority. TheBathAuthority.com. A better bath awaits.
What you got there?
Dramamine.
Why?
Because we're promoting the cane table.
It's part of the Envy collection at Penny Mustard.
But that's for seasickness.
Look at the cane table. What do you see?
Style.
Charm.
Good old American craftsmanship that lasts for generations.
Okay, sure, but look closer. What do you see?
I see a beveled edge, conversion varnish, and a striking leg design.
I see a dining room table that's optionizable with as many leaves as you need to fit a family of 2 or 22.
When I look at the cane table, I see a world of possibilities.
Yeah, but look at the shape of the cane table.
It's boat-shaped.
Precisely.
You mean you get seasick just by looking at anything shaped like a boat?
Uh-oh, I'm feeling woozy.
Don't miss the boat. Come see the cane table and the Envy collection, starting at $18.38, paired with Encore side chairs for $5.50 each at Penny Mustard.
Showrooms in Milwaukee and Chicago.
PennyMustard.com.
Boat-shaped versions of what people want.
Penny Mustard Furnishings.
Traffic is sponsored by Center Point's Pontoon and Deck Boat Preseason Sale. Happening now, it's Center Point.
Rev up your summer at Center Point's Pontoon and Deck Boat Preseason Sale. Happening now. Unbeatable deals from over 10 top-notch boat and motor brands. Center Point, Pewaukee, Highway 16 and Capitol Drive.
Traffic and weather, let's get you where you need to with Debbie Lazaga.
All right, Julia, we do have this problem in Ozaukee County on Mequon Road. Basically, both directions are closed on Mequon Road at about Cedarburg Road. So that's Highway 57. So just be careful if you're going to be heading through there. You're not going to be able to get through, technically. We do have an accident on 894 southbound at Oklahoma Avenue. It was in traffic. They were able to move everything off to the right shoulder. Still, though, delay is going all the way back to the zoo. On eastbound 94, backing up from about 84th Street through the stadium interchange, westbound 94, slow out of the Marquette, all the way out past almost to Hawley Road. I'm Debbie Lazaga with your WTMJ Johnson & Sons Paving Time Saver Traffic.
It's 62 degrees right now in Milwaukee. Tonight it'll be cloudy with a low of 44. Tomorrow will be mild. The high will be 62 at the lake and even warmer inland, 65. Thursday, rain is likely with a high of 50 degrees. Friday, early showers likely with a high of 53 degrees. Saturday, mostly sunny. You get to see the sun. The high will be 60 degrees.
A story that we have been following for months out of Michigan. A judge sentenced the parents of a Michigan school shooter to at least 10 years in prison today for failing to take steps that could have prevented their son from killing four students in 2021. Jennifer and James Crumbly were held equally responsible and were both found guilty of involuntary manslaughter after prosecutors presented evidence of an unsecured gun at home and indifference toward the teen's mental health. At sentencing today, The mother of one of the victims, Madison Baldwin, was the victim, tearfully recounted the contrast between her parenting and that of the Crumbly parents.
While your son was hearing voices and asking for help, I was helping Madison pick out her senior classes.
Heartbreaking testimony today.
Terrible.
Wanted to get reaction and perspective from one of the guys who's really good at discussing this sort of thing. He is renowned criminal defense attorney Jonathan Lavoie, who is with us this afternoon. Jonathan, thanks for making some time for us.
No problem.
This is literally unprecedented. What's your reaction to what happened in Michigan?
John, this is a big deal. I think this is going to have a ripple effect across the country. I think that the community gets sick of these school shootings, and they're looking for people to hold responsible other than the kids. And I think this is going to open up a lot of prosecutions in the United States and potentially here in Wisconsin.
What do you think this says about gun laws? Is that also part of this?
I don't think so. I think this has more to do with gun responsibility. I think the community demands that parents who introduce their kids to guns certainly be aware of mental health issues, number one. And number two, be responsible about gun locks and trigger locks and responsible training, those types of things. And clearly in the Crumbly case, those things were not present.
I think a lot of people, I'll speak for myself, I've had conversations where something tragic happens and the shooter takes their own life. And you say, what a coward. I mean, gosh, he couldn't even stand up and be responsible for what he did. And I think you're right, Jonathan. This is now a way for some to feel like, well, we'll hold someone accountable because the guy who pulled the trigger is no longer here. As a criminal defense attorney, do you think this is good law or do you think this is a bad precedent?
Boy, you know, I think it's a difficult precedent. I wouldn't say it's bad, but it's very hard to hold somebody who didn't pull the trigger responsible for a homicide. I think it requires significant evidence that the parents in a situation like this were woefully or grossly negligent or responsible for not protecting society, knowing if their kid had mental health issues like this. And certainly under the circumstances of the Crumbly case, we knew that he was drawing pictures and was exhibiting signs of hearing voices, and the parents simply didn't do anything to stop it.
Exactly. I watched Jennifer Crumbly's case from beginning to end, like on 2X, like on speed. What was really interesting is that, you know, as a criminal defense attorney, Jonathan Lavoie, do you think that the school could have been charged? Why wasn't the school charged? Because they're the ones that spotted this wild drawing and then didn't check the kid's backpack, which had the loaded gun in it, and let him go back to class.
Yeah, that's exactly right. And I think a lot of people want to hold the school responsible, too. And I think the school definitely had responsibility here. But I think the buck stops with the parents, because the parents are the ones that are with the child every day. They know the child's mental health issues, and they're the ones that bought the gun and provided the gun to the child. So I think that they have a little bit more responsibility than the school, because the school didn't notify the parents and ask them to pick up the child, and the parents refused to do so.
Criminal defense attorney Jonathan Lavoie is with us. Jonathan, I know it's not the perfect comparison, but we already do charge and convict people who don't pull the trigger. I mean, if you're part of a bank robbery and you're sitting out in the car and the guys inside end up shooting and killing a bank teller, you can be charged and convicted, right?
That's exactly right. We have party to a crime liability in Wisconsin, so people who are in a conspiracy or aiding and abetting somebody can be held responsible for what other people do. In this situation, of course, the parents were claiming, we didn't know what was happening. We didn't know what our child was going to do. This was unpredictable. So this really came down to the gross negligence statute in Michigan that really had to do with the parents knew the danger and just didn't avoid the danger by taking appropriate steps.
The sentencing of 10 years, Jennifer wanted to have 5 years of house arrest. The husband apparently was caught on the jail phone call threatening the prosecutor in some way, but they both got 10 years. What do you think about that sentencing?
Boy, you know, it's tough because this is the first time we've ever seen a sentence like this, so it's really hard to compare it to anything else. But anytime somebody's held responsible for, at least in some part, taking somebody's life, there's going to be severe consequences. And I think these are severe consequences. I think it will send a clear message to parents that, number one, they have to be careful about providing guns or access to guns to their children. And number two, we have to be very cognizant of children that are asking for help with severe mental health issues.
I spoke to someone today, Jonathan, who said, if this happened now, where do we draw the line? If a kid says to his mom and dad, you know what? I'm going to get that video game system, whether you give me the money or not. And then the kid goes out and steals a video game system. Can the parents be held liable for that? Because they knew that the kid was insinuating or threatening to steal the video game system.
Yeah, John, that's right. It's a slippery slope. I mean, you just never know how far you can take this stuff. But in this situation, because it's a homicide-level case and so many children lost their lives, I think that the prosecution took a risk and said, we're going to try this out and see how it goes. I don't think it's going to necessarily bleed down to lower-level cases, but I think it's very likely that Wisconsin will see a prosecution like this in the future if something similar were to happen here.
I want to read you a quote from somebody on the text line who just sent this in, and I'm hearing a lot of this sort of sentiment. I want you to react from the perspective of a criminal defense attorney. Here it is. I have no sympathy for these smug, negligent parents because one of them bought the gun and both of them failed to be concerned about their son's questionable comments and behavior that could have prevented the shooting. Despite the red flags, they allowed him continued access to the firearm. I guess one of my questions to you is perspective on, you deal with this all the time. When there's a jury of people and they can see the parents and they did appear smug and they did appear to have all the answers, how much does that play into what happened in court?
It's a huge issue. There are many people in our state that are pro-gun, and that's totally fine. But many of those same people are very responsible gun owners and people that lock up their guns and don't provide it to children and those types of things. So in a jury trial situation, the attitude these parents had clearly was part of their demise and one of the reasons why they were convicted.
I guess I want to follow up with something you've already alluded to. You know Wisconsin law better than either of us. Is it probable that this will come to Wisconsin and other states?
I believe it's absolutely likely that there will be prosecutions like this throughout the country. Whether it comes to Wisconsin will really depend on the facts of the case. I think there has to be severe facts related to the parents' behavior, that the parents knew what was happening with the gun, that they provided the gun to the student, and that there were likely scenarios that could have prevented this. So I think that in the right fact pattern, similar to the one in Michigan, we could see a prosecution like this here in Wisconsin.
As a criminal defense attorney, how difficult of a case would this have been for you?
I think that the clients themselves would have been very challenging. They didn't do themselves any favors in this situation. But I think it's an incredibly important case about who is responsible when kids act out like this. Are parents truly responsible for the acts of their kids? And at what level can parents be held responsible? This is an extreme example. But you know, this would be a challenging case to defend under any circumstance, particularly with these two defendants.
Renowned criminal defense attorney, Jonathan Lavoie. It's Kim and Lavoie. We appreciate you being with us, Jonathan. Thank you so much for the perspective.
Thank you.
What a case, unlike any literally that we've ever had in our country.
I'd be afraid to be a parent. I don't know.
It is unnerving.
A lot.
Yeah.
It's a lot.
Yeah. Although I think he nailed it, though. These parents were so... their behavior just seems so inappropriate.
Oh, when
so
Jennifer,
cold.
Yeah, when Jennifer Crumbly was on the stand, they said, you know, what did you lose in all of this? Or, you know, what do you think about the aftermath? And she was just talking about herself.
Right.
Not about the children that were shot and a teacher who survived.
Yeah.
Four people died in that.
356 at WTMJ. Business headlines. Let's get to those. Here's Sean Ryan at the Milwaukee Business Journal.
Epic Systems' eclectic office campus in Verona is about to get more interesting. The city approved new buildings with architecture echoing Lord of the Rings, the Harry Potter books, and Wizard of Oz. Arizona-based Pickleball Kingdom is not moving into Ruby Isle and Brookfield for its much-anticipated first Wisconsin location. The company had considered moving into the former Pick and Save store space, but the plan became cost-prohibitive. Paloma Taco opens its Bayview restaurant on Kinnickinnick Avenue on April 18th. This is the second Paloma restaurant for owner Patty Ford, who opened on North Avenue about 4 years ago. This is Sean Ryan with MilwaukeeBusinessJournal.com on News Radio WTMJ.
WTMJ, W277CV, and WKTI HD2 Milwaukee. From the Annex Wealth Management Studios, this is News Radio WTMJ, a Good Karma brand station.
We're sponsored by the Pfister Hotel. Make your reservations today. Visit thepfisterhotel.com.
For over 130 years, the Pfister Hotel in downtown Milwaukee has been delighting guests with impeccable service and luxurious accommodations. Celebrate your next special occasion with a stay at the Pfister. Enjoy fine dining at its acclaimed restaurants and pamper yourself with a service from the Well Spa and Salon. Experience the hotel's afternoon tea program or take in live music with the best views of the city from Blue, the 23rd floor cocktail lounge. There's always a reason to celebrate with the Pfister Hotel. Make your reservations today at thepfisterhotel.com.
Hey, Connect Chiropractic, I was there today. I was at the Delafield location. They hooked me up and took care of me, and they're gentle and nuanced at Connect Chiropractic. They're not hopping on the table, cracking your back, and twisting you all over the place. That's not their technique. And I feel better after going to Connect. I really, really do. I want you to know what it's like. There's an open house on Wednesday, April 24th from 6 to 8. Dr. Alex, Dr. Olivia, Dr. Marley will all be at the office. You can meet the docs. I will be there. See how chiropractic care can help you. It's April 24th from 6 to 8 at the TOSA location. Come on out. See the technique. See the facility. Say hello. There will be food. It's going to be a good time. Wednesday, April 24th, 6 to 8, Connect Chiropractic. Open house. Hope to see you there.
Since 1955, Geist Garage Doors has been the trusted authority in Wisconsin. Hey, it's Greg Mancik. Don't let a busted garage door get you down. Give my friends at Geist a call. Doors and openers for every budget are available, and they'll even build custom designs to meet your exact needs. Check out geistdoors.com or call 262-784-4250. Or do what I did. Check out their amazing showroom in Brookfield featuring hundreds of doors, openers, and their custom design room. Wherever you are in southeast Wisconsin, don't think twice. Call Geist.
Don't think twice.
Hey, WTMJ's John Mercure here. If you're like me, my home has become my happy place. It's happier now thanks to Serta Pro Painters. They are simply the best in the business. They will take care of the scuffs, the faded colors. They'll make your home a new home, inside or outside. They did the work at our house. It was quick, easy, and so, so affordable. Their estimates are always easy. You get a quote right away. It's simply the best in the business. Schedule your free estimate online at CertaPro.com. That's Serta with a C. When choosing a painting professional, the choice is simple. Choose happy. Choose Serta Pro Painters.
Don't let a cold, sinus infection, or allergies ruin your day. Breathe easier, sleep better, and feel healthier with Navage. Visit Navage.com, Walmart, Walgreens, CVS, or a store near you.
The Original Botanas Restaurant. Delectable entrees, 50 top-shelf tequilas, 20 different margarita flavors. Stop by for lunch or before or after the big game. The Original Botanas on 5th Street.
Casa es su casa. That's Botanas.
I'm Brett Machke, and you're due for service.
Ridgelands. Traffic is sponsored by the Wisconsin State Fair. Wisconsin State Fair has $12 group tickets on sale now. Hurry, the sale ends April 30th. Visit wistatefair.com to save big for group tickets.
1-0, high fly ball, right center field. Racing back is Fairchild. Back is Thompson at the wall. He reaches up, and it is gone. Bryce Terang.
The Brewers continue their series against the Reds in Cincinnati. Our coverage of the series continues tonight at 5:05 on your home of the Milwaukee Brewers. News Radio 620, WTMJ, Milwaukee.
It's 4:01. I'm John Mercure. Your top story, a man shot and killed by Waukesha police.
I'm Julia Fellow, a deadly crash in Caledonia.
I'm Debbie Lozaga. Still have the problem on Mequon Road, closed in both directions right at Highway 57, so watch out for that. Try and avoid the area if you can. 894 southbound, an accident at Oklahoma Avenue. Still there, still off on the right shoulder, still causing delays back to the zoo. Southbound 41 backing up from Appleton Avenue all the way down past Capitol Drive. I'm Debbie Lozaga with your WTMJ Johnson & Sons Paving Time Saver Traffic.
Tonight, clear skies, a low of 43 degrees. Tomorrow, sunny and mild, a high of 67. It's currently 62. From the WTMJ Breaking News Center, Waukesha police shot and killed a man wanted for attempted vehicle theft at the CarMax on Blue Mound Road. Police Chief Daniel Thompson says this morning's shooting happened after a foot pursuit, and the suspect made overt actions consistent with an individual drawing a firearm. A preliminary investigation determined the suspect did not have a gun. Four officers are on administrative leave while Milwaukee police lead the investigation.
Caledonia Police and State Patrol investigating a deadly crash that killed a man from West Allis. It happened at State Highway 38 and Embertson Road in Caledonia this morning. A Hyundai Tucson driven by a man from West Allis collided with a PT Cruiser, rolled over, then struck a pole. The 36-year-old man died at the scene. The driver of the PT Cruiser, an 18-year-old woman from Racine, remained on scene. She was rushed to the hospital with injuries.
Questions still remain after a six-year-old died from a house fire in Milwaukee. Rashawn Wilson III died in the hospital just 4 days after the fire on April 2nd. On Monday, authorities were still boarding up the scorched house left with broken windows and a burnt roof. A neighbor in the area tells TMJ4 News the house was a source of concern for the neighborhood.
Since they moved in, which was, what, a year ago, it was always something going on, like fighting. Like I said, people come in and shoot up the house.
The Milwaukee Police Department says they are not investigating the fire as an arson case.
Governor Tony Evers signs the PRINCE Act, aiming to fill gaps in missing children statewide alerts.
Within the next few weeks, Governor Tony Evers says a purple alert will be implemented, broadening missing children alerts across Wisconsin.
Any system that we put in place may have gaps, and you don't recognize gaps until it's too late.
State Senator LaTanya Johnson was key in the implementation of the PRINCE Act, but credits work on both sides of the aisle to get the job done.
This is an example of what should happen when we find out that there are loopholes or fragments in laws.
Adam Roberts, WTMJ News.
The CDC highlights an alarming statistic on women and mammograms. ABC's Derek Dennis.
A report from the CDC shows thousands of women between the ages of 50 and 74 are not receiving life-saving mammograms. The data varies state to state, but the study found the more health-related needs a woman had, the less likely she was to get a mammogram. Other barriers include food insecurity, social isolation, employment issues, and a lack of reliable transportation. Breast cancer causes more than 40,000 deaths among women in the U.S. a year, a number that's been decreasing. But not equally among all racial and ethnic groups. Derek Dennis, ABC News.
Members of Harley-Davidson's largest labor union have overwhelmingly ratified a new five-year contract with the company. The Milwaukee Business Journal reports the new deal provides a 19% wage increase over the life of the contract and additional insurance, retirement, and vacation benefits. Contracts were scheduled to expire Sunday for Harley-Davidson employees in Menominee Falls and Tomahawk.
Coming up, fires, cats, and a total solar eclipse.
Setting unlimited WTMJ News time, 4:05.
This report sponsored by the Fradert and the Medical College of Wisconsin Health Network.
Heart disease won't stop us. Diabetes won't slow us down. Allergies, high blood pressure, shoulder pain, cancer. Nothing will keep us from pushing Wisconsin ahead. Because with the Fradert and the Medical College of Wisconsin Health Network, forward progress is what we stand for. That means always pushing and always innovating. With new technologies and breakthrough treatments that make life better, whether we're sick or well. It means providing more convenience and more ways to receive medical excellence for all your health needs, for big and small. It means being there for you. Our family, caring for yours. So let's keep raising the bar. Let's keep testing the limits of what medicine can do. Let's push ahead and make life here as great as it can be. Visit Fradert.com to find out how.
From the biggest plays on the court to the comments made in the locker room after, an in-depth recap of every Bucks game in 6 minutes. No more, no less. Bucks in Six provides game recaps for every game. Hear the high-flying dunks from Giannis.
Puts it on the floor, spins down the lane, and plunges it through.
Or the deep threes from Dame.
Dame time has arrived with 107.
Bucks in Six on the Bucks Plus Audio Network. Find it now on Bucks.com/plus or on Spotify, Apple, and wherever you get your podcasts.
WTMJ's Vince Vitrano here. We agree, right? Potholes stink, and our recent weather means this could be one of the worst years yet. Johnson & Sons Paving is up to the challenge. This team has over two decades experience. When potholes pop up in your asphalt, Johnson & Sons Paving will patch them up or replace the whole parking lot. Take a look at JohnsonAndSonsPaving.com. Sign a parking lot paving contract before May 31st, and you might just get me out on the job site working with the crew. Find full contest details at WTMJ.com/contests.
Setting unlimited WTMJ News time, 4:07.
Eclipse, fire, and cats, a dangerous combination in Ohio.
Just around the time Canton, Ohio was darkened by Monday's total solar eclipse, a house fire broke out in the city. Arriving firefighters finding a woman outside who said the fire was in her kitchen, blaming it on one of her cats accidentally turning on a burner on her stove. That was one of 37 cats the firefighters found in the home as they put out the fire. Some cats given oxygen for smoke inhalation. All survived, the woman uninjured. Dave Packer, ABC News.
Time for a WTMJ sports update from the Gruber Law Office's One Call, That's All Sports Desk. After a wild 10-8 loss to the Reds last night, the Brewers will try again tonight in Game 2. Coverage begins at 5:05 on WTMJ. Our Bucks aim to snap a four-game losing streak tonight against the Eastern Conference leading Boston Celtics at 6:30. With four games to play in the regular season, the Bucks are currently one game ahead of the Magic and Knicks for second place in the Eastern Conference playoff race.
Siding Unlimited WTMJ News Time, 4:08.
This report sponsored by Pella of Wisconsin. Discover Pella now, pay later at PellaWI.com.
Beautify your entertainment space with Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Hi, this is Gina Della from Pella. Turn your ordinary space into something extraordinary with brand new Pella windows. The luxurious look, sleek design, and custom colors available is guaranteed to give your home the extra pop to entertain and keep you comfortable. At Pella, we see windows differently. We have the highest rated energy efficient products and a complete range of durable, functional, and high quality products that bring out the best of your home. Plus, getting the perfect windows and doors for your home has never been easier. Right now, get 0% interest for up to 36 months or no down payment, no interest, and no payments for up to 18 months if you book before April 30th. That's right, get 0% interest for up to 36 months or no down payment, no interest, and no payments for up to 18 months if you book before April 30th. Take ownership of your living space and make it a place worth living with Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin.
Wisconsin's Afternoon News is on the air, broadcasting live from the Annex Wealth Management Studios at The Avenue in beautiful downtown Milwaukee. Here are your hosts, John McCure and Julia Fellow.
All right, thanks for being with us on this Tuesday. It is 4:09. I have an update for you to a story that's left us feeling rather uneasy. It's a tough story.
Exactly a week ago today, John, someone walking along the lakefront at Warnemont Park found a human leg, severed leg, that washed ashore. A person of interest was taken into custody on Friday. And he lives about 10 minutes from that scene at 39th and Oklahoma. It became a huge crime scene. Lots of people there, FBI now involved. And even though this man is not officially charged, our partners at TMJ4 News have identified him because he was named in open court today, so are we. Prosecutors asked to keep Maxwell Anderson behind bars for another 72 hours. And the court granted it on the evidence gathered so far in his house. So this is what we've learned in court from just this morning related to this severed leg that was found in Cudahy by someone that was just walking their dog. Investigators say blood was discovered on a comforter and in the stairwell of Anderson's home. There's now lab results that are expected to come back tomorrow. And they've added, since those samples were submitted for testing, additional body parts have been found. Yes, more human remains were found in Milwaukee over this weekend. Milwaukee police already confirmed with us a human body part was found near 30th and Lisbon Friday and 30th and Galena. That was really left us really uneasy.
Terrible.
And it was also revealed in court today, to keep this man behind bars, investigators believe it's all connected to Anderson. Yesterday, I spoke to a retired training police sergeant with Milwaukee Police, and his name is Stephen Duckhorn. I was waiting to reveal this part of our interview until the suspect was identified. It discusses more strange things around Anderson's home at 39th and Oklahoma. That is a crime scene. This includes neighbors complaining about a huge hole that Anderson dug up in his backyard.
A friend of the suspect, we'll say for now, that came forward and said the person of interest was building about a 5 by 6 foot bunker in his backyard near his house. And the neighbor kind of casually said, hey, you don't want to do that because your dog is going to end up falling into that or something. And he said, no, I'm building this because I want to build an underground bunker, like my own basement. And that really struck the neighbor odd because he just felt the timing of everything that's happening. What is this guy building? It's nobody builds that type of hole in their basement. Nobody's going to destroy their property like that.
Again, that's a retired training police sergeant with 25 years in the force with Milwaukee Police describing this. And he was uneasy with this. Another question, big one, identifying these body parts. Anderson's attorney, Anthony Cotton, you may remember that man's name. He was a defense attorney for Morgan Geyser in the Slenderman stabbing case. He revealed, after the court appearance, additional details of the evidence that prosecution says they have. This includes cell phone tracking and a written statement Anderson had contact with a person who is missing. Who is that person missing? Police are not saying, but we do know there is a critically missing person in Milwaukee right now, in the same area where the latest two discoveries of body parts were found. 19-year-old Shade Carlina Robinson. She was last seen near Commerce and Pleasant on the Lower East Side Monday, and her car was found torched near 30th and Lisbon Tuesday morning.
And police today continue to search different areas, railroad tracks, fields, yards. Sources tell us that it is continuing, and the discoveries they're making are less than pleasant. It's an odd, uneasy story. We'll continue to keep you updated. It is 4:13 at WTMJ.
Tony Drake here from Drake & Associates. Big news! Our Retirement Ready radio show is moving to a new time slot. Catch us at noon every Saturday. At Drake & Associates, we craft tailor-made plans that not only meet your financial needs, but align seamlessly with your unique lifestyle. Tune in at noon on Saturdays and get retirement ready.
Drake & Associates LLC is an independent investment advisory firm that offers a variety of different investment vehicles. This commercial is provided for informational purposes only and should not be construed as individual investment advice. Drake & Associates LLC does not provide legal or tax advice.
WTMJ's John Merck here for Town Bank. Town Bank, involved in your community and making a difference in our communities. I like that. I'm a Town Bank guy, and it matters to me that they're philanthropic if they're involved. What also matters to me, they've got the best banking solutions at Town Bank. They've got the best customer service at Town Bank. Do you ever check your bank account and feel like you aren't saving anything at all? At Town Bank, they view banking differently, and they want to see your savings grow. They have amazing new CD rates. They encourage you to check that out. Not always about the saving account. So you can earn even more and sit back and relax. Stop banking the same way, expecting different results. Start earning more. It's Town Bank. I love the Junior Savers Club account that they have. It's absolutely just the best thing going. It teaches your kids about how to save and about money, and it's fun, activities, different get-togethers. Check it out at townbank.us. It's Town Bank. It's Wisconsin's bank. It's my bank. I know I'm a little biased, but it's the best bank. Bank differently with Town Bank. Member FDIC.
We asked people why they sold their homes to Grandview Homes instead of using a real estate agent.
I decided that spending the time and money to rehab the unit and sell it through conventional means was not in my best interest. They give you a fair price offer, close quickly, and pay promptly. The process with Grandview was virtually effortless.
Whether you have a hard-to-sell home, want a stress-free sale, or simply need to sell your home fast, Grandview Homes is the name you know and the name you can trust. Visit GrandviewHomes.com to discover the easiest and fastest way to sell a home.
Traffic is sponsored by CenterPoint. CenterPoint's pontoon and deck boat preseason sale is happening now.
Rev up your summer at CenterPoint's pontoon and deck boat preseason sale happening now. Unbeatable deals from over 10 top-notch boat and motor brands. CenterPoint Pewaukee, Highway 16 and Capitol Drive.
Traffic and weather, it's Debbie Lozaga. How's that ride rolling, Deb?
Well, we still have this issue in Ozaukee County. Mequon Road is closed in both directions at Cedarburg Road. They're calling it an incident. Not quite sure exactly what it is, but you won't be able to get through there. So avoid the area if you can. Southbound 43 backing up from before Hampton Avenue all the way down past Keith, and then back on the brakes from Fond du Lac Avenue through the Marquette and over the high-rise bridge. On the northbound side is backed up out of the Marquette to Keefe. And then on 894 southbound, we're still dealing with some delays. There was an accident at Oklahoma Avenue. They were able to move off to the side of the road. Unfortunately, though, we got backups from the zoo pretty much past that point all the way down and around the Hale Interchange. I'm Debbie Lozaga with your WTMJ Johnson & Sons Paving Time Saver Traffic.
The WTMJ 5-day forecast. Tonight, partly cloudy, a low of 44 degrees. Tomorrow, increasing clouds, mild, high of 65. On Thursday, windy, rain is likely, a high of 50. On Friday, rain is likely in the morning again, a high of 53. On Saturday, sunny with a high of 60 degrees. Right now in Milwaukee, it's 61.
I got a pocket full of sunshine. I got a love and I know that it's all mine.
I am so glad that the solar eclipse day is done.
Could you imagine being a reporter yesterday and you know that the boss, what kind of sound bites does the boss want?
They pump it up. They want you to pump it up.
But like not your reaction, which
right.
was what?
when you went up there and you saw it?
Yeah, it's just okay. Yeah, I don't really care. No, they don't want that.
They want this. Take a listen to people losing their minds.
It's amazing, amazingly beautiful, once in a lifetime, beautiful.
You sound emotional.
Tears in my eyes.
And this white light, it's like...
You've never seen something like this before.
It's like heaven is calling down. It's amazing.
Come on, are you serious right now?
That's what that. But honestly, when you're at these stories,
oh yeah,
that's the money.
Well, that's why you and I have been in the field a lot lately, and I mean in our careers, and people always ask us like, how do you find those insane people? Because those are the people you want, the people that are the most nuts, the most over the top.
I have a friend who worked in Memphis, and every year for when Elvis's birthday comes up, a man from Australia comes and wails, cries, and he's always on every single year. Okay, here's a reporter losing his mind. You know, some of them were not very impressed, like us. Here's a reporter really over the top. But, you know, he's doing his job.
What an event to win. Oh, my gosh. Wow. That is absolutely spectacular, even with the thin clouds that we've been seeing here.
Oh, please. Come on.
Oh, he had cloud cover, too.
Yeah, please.
Okay, and this is why I love Vince Vitrano. Because he's the host of Wisconsin's Morning News. We all know him and love him. He made it to 99% totality, and this was his reaction with Eric Bilstead.
Oh, come on. It can't, this can't be it. This is it. Oh, not worth it. Totally not worth it. Oh, my God.
He is telling the truth.
Totally not worth it.
But, John, then Captain Kirk himself puts all of this into perspective for us. This is what 93-year-old William Shatner had to say about this event.
It was understanding that there are forces beyond anything we can understand. Just the fact that we're looking at a celestial body going through its paces. These moments in space reminds you of how here in this one instance we could fathom what happened. And those of us who are lucky to see the totality of it, it's a lifetime experience.
Protect William Shatner at all costs. I love that man.
I love him too. I just love to listen to him. And how old is he?
93.
And listen to him, how sharp he is.
I know. But it's true. It really is special. I'm just, you know, kidding around, but...
I want to take this opportunity to publicly thank the bosses at Good Karma Brands who clearly like Julie and John better than Vince and Eric because they got sent to middle of nowhere Indiana to look at something that was almost a total eclipse.
They were such good sports.
Yeah, there's
that
something.
That was so great.
It's good to be us. Happy total eclipse day after, everybody. Dave Drake Camp Heating. Let me tell you about my friends at Dave Drake Camp Heating. They get it. They understand it. They know that sometimes you need a new system. Sometimes you just need a little bit of work. I've been with them for a decade plus. The same guy actually comes to my house every single year. That says a lot about the company, too. They installed a new furnace and new air conditioner at the same time a few years back. The comfort in my home has never been better thanks to Dave Drake Camp Heating. And you know what? They understand the crazy seasons. Cold, hot, windy, snowy, rain. Sometimes all in the same day because Dave Drake Camp has been here in Wisconsin for 40-plus years. They're prepared for anything. So whether you're experiencing a home comfort dilemma or you need new equipment, you need routine maintenance, whatever you need, make sure your system is ready. Get in touch with Dave Drake Camp Heating today because your comfort is their family's tradition. DaveDragCamp.com. Check them out today. DaveDragCamp.com.
Before you go looking for an area rug that you'll have to settle for because you think that the one you really want will be out of your budget, come to Design Exchange, where you'll find a formidable selection of Oriental, Persian, and other wool area rug choices at 25 to 70% off retail. This is Katie with Design Exchange, where discerning buyers with discriminating tastes come to find premium home decor on consignment at a value. Design Exchange in Heartland and Pewaukee.
Design Exchange.
If you're trying to find really good, high-end, distinctive furniture, the kind they just don't make anymore, then come to Design Exchange. But you better get here quickly, because the best furniture we take in on consignment doesn't usually last long. It may be vintage, it may have once been out of your range, but now you'll find it's priced right. This is Katie with Design Exchange, where discerning buyers with discriminating taste come to find premium home decor at a value.
Design Exchange.
WTMJ's Eric Bilstead here. Do you have achy joints, like a bad knee or maybe an elbow that barks at you, and you want to get help, but the idea of surgery or steroids makes you cringe? Well, there is another way. QC Kinetics. It's the future of medicine. QC Kinetics is the nation's leader in regenerative medicine. We're talking natural biologics using your body's own power to repair and restore damaged tissue. QC Kinetics is under the leadership of National Medical Director Dr. Mitchell Sheinkup. Dr. Sheinkup's a pioneer in this field. 20 years of clinical work, tons of research, and he wants to get you relief with a needle, not a knife. QC Kinetics. They've got two locations, one in Greenfield, another in Mequon. Call today to find out how they can help you. QC Kinetics, 414-285-3474. That's 414-3474. Get your free consultation from QC Kinetics, 414-285-3474.
Welcome back to Wisconsin's Afternoon News. Okay, so we've been teasing this all day. The household items that harbor the most bacteria in your house. So we have these lists all the time, but this list I found interesting because some of these items are things that you've never thought about. All right, I'll speak for myself. I had never thought about. The most dirty thing, they say, in most people's houses is the razor in the shower. So I keep my razor in my shower. Do you?
Ew. Yeah? You wouldn't tell me any of this.
I know.
Before we went on
I wanted you to be surprised. They say that you should take the razor out of your shower every single time you use it and completely dry it off before you use it again. Who does that?
I can see that, though. The bacteria.
I can see it. I know. Mold kind of gets weird in there, right? But I don't do that. Do you do that? They also say that you should only use the razor, the hand razor, 5 times.
What?
I'm frugal. There's no way I'm only using that 5 times. My dad told me when I was 12 years old, I never forget this. He said, if I ever had all the money that I could possibly have, I would use the hand razor once and throw it away. And I just remember that. That was like his extravagant, I would never do that. How many times do you think you use the razor before you throw it out?
I don't know. Hundreds?
That's a lot. That's a lot.
I don't know.
Whoa, that's like years.
My dad has like 10.
Yeah. So the razor. The razor's really bad. Liquid makeup. Really bad, especially the sponges and the brushes that
That's
you ladies
what I just
use.
Put on. It's so gross.
They say you should wash that like every third time that you use either a sponge or a brush. That's not practical, is it?
No. The drying time is long.
Right, the drying time. All right, here's another one I hadn't thought of. We both have dogs.
Mm-hmm.
The pet bed. This totally makes sense, but I didn't think about it. The pet goes out, does its business, sniffs around the yard, comes in, and then it lays at the foot of your bed or in the living room on its little pet bed. I never wash that thing. Maybe like once or twice a year. They say that pet bed should be washed every week.
My husband does once a month.
Okay, that's
pretty
good.
If it wasn't for him, thank goodness for my husband.
That's pretty good.
We'd have disease.
Yeah, because I just never really thought about that one. Contact lens cases. Do you wear contacts?
That's why I have dailies.
Okay, so you just use them and throw them out.
Every day you can switch them out.
I would kind of think contact lens cases are clean because there's like cleaning solution in the contact lens case. Wouldn't that kill everything?
Have you ever done the hydrogen peroxide? Do you have contacts?
No, I don't.
Oh.
I don't.
You got to wait for it all to stop bubbling. And if you do it early, whew, that in your eyes, it's...
Oh, really?
It hurts so bad.
And one other one, cutting boards. And I would think that... A wood cutting board is worse because it's porous, so it can kind of absorb things. Wouldn't that get more stuff? They say that wood cutting boards are better from a bacteria standpoint than plastic ones.
Okay.
That the wood has certain, what does it say exactly? It says on a wood cutting board, they have resins that are antibacterial on many cutting boards. So they say the plastic ones are dirtier than the average toilet seat.
I'm throwing out all of my cutting boards.
Me too, and my razors.
Oh,
razors, out. See you later. Just interesting stuff, huh? Time for the WTMJ Annex Wealth Management Market Update. Kind of a mixed bag today. The S&P 500 was up 8 points. The NASDAQ was up 53. The Dow was down 9 points. Annex Wealth Management, know the difference.
Welcome to the Knowledge Brokers, weekly feature covering the dynamics of the insurance market, how it affects Wisconsin businesses and folks who live here. Sponsored by the original Knowledge Broker, R&R Insurance. And joining us today, Jeff Salasinski, Vice President of Insurance Operations. Jeff, we were just talking the other week about cyber attacks. Director of the FBI called it the defining threat of our generation. What should businesses and individuals be doing to protect themselves?
Thank you, Vince. Great to be here. The way we're looking at cybercrime at R&R is it's no longer merely a work problem. Mm-hmm. It can have a devastating effect on your personal life as well. These events are more severe, they happen more frequently, and we've seen them with some very revered brands in our area just recently.
All falls under the umbrella of cyber insurance, but I imagine policies vary widely in terms of what they offer.
Yes, these policies are very different. One thing to be mindful of is many companies offer a product that is really a add-on endorsement mm-hmm. to your particular policy. It doesn't provide a lot of coverage. It provides a low limit of insurance with a lot of exclusions. It may be very inadequate for what you need. What you're looking for is a standalone cyber insurance policy. This policy offers, in addition to an insurance reimbursement, offers a team of legal experts, IT professionals, public relations assistants to help you as an individual or your business get back on its feet after an event.
See, what I heard you say there is a team of people to whom I have access because I don't just need a check. I need help cleaning up this mess.
Yes, and at R&R Insurance, we've been ahead of the cyber game. We've had our team of dedicated cyber experts in place for almost 10 years now. This is an area we know well. It's a suite of solutions we can custom design to help support your business or you as an individual.
That's Jeff from R&R Insurance. Great info, Jeff. More information online at myknowledgebroker.com.
Wisconsin's afternoon news on Wisconsin's radio station, News Radio WTMJ.
It's 4:30. I'm John Mercure. Your top story updates on a severed leg case.
I'm Julia Fellow, a Midwest favorite comedian at State Fair.
I'm Debbie Lozaga. We are still seeing the problem in Ozaukee County. Mequon Road closed in both directions at Cedarburg Road because of what they're calling an incident. Southbound 43 slowing from Silver Spring down past Capitol Drive, and then you're back on the brakes from Fond du Lac down through the Marquette. On the northbound side, slow out of the Marquette all the way up to Keefe, and westbound 94 heavy out of the Marquette all the way to about Mitchell Boulevard, with the eastbound side heavy from 84th Street through the stadium interchange. While you're out at navigating the roads as quickly and safely as possible, if you do happen to see something we should know about, call the WTMJ Hall Volkswagen Traffic Tip Line at 414-238-9329. I'm Debbie Lozaga with your WTMJ Johnson & Sons Paving Time Saver Traffic.
Tonight it's going to be cloudy with a low of 44. Tomorrow will be mild. The high will be 62 at the lake and 65 inland. It's currently 62 degrees right now in Milwaukee.
From the WTMJ Breaking News Center, prosecutors are asking that a man remain in custody who's considered a person of interest in the investigation of a human leg found in Cudahy.
Warnemar Park, the man believed to be a person of interest in the case, was in court this morning. The Milwaukee Journal Sentinel reports prosecutors are asking to keep him in custody for another 72 hours while they try to determine what charges to file. Police have not identified whose leg it is, nor have they said if other remains that were found in Milwaukee this past weekend are connected to the case. Eric Bilstead, WTMJ News.
A 50-year-old wanted for attempted vehicle theft at CarMax in Waukesha, dead after officers shot him.
The suspect was transferred to an area hospital for advanced care, where it's later pronounced deceased.
Police Chief Daniel Thompson says the suspect, quote, made overt actions that are consistent with an individual drawing a firearm, though a preliminary investigation determined the suspect did not have a gun.
The officers acted within state statutes and fulfilled the mission of the Waukesha Police Department, which is a pledge to serve with integrity, honor, and courage.
Four officers have been placed on leave. Milwaukee police will lead the investigation. Adam Roberts, WTMJ News.
A 75-year-old stabbed to death in Milwaukee early this morning. Milwaukee police investigating this as a domestic violence-related stabbing at 89th and Adler. Police are seeking a known suspect in the case.
There's been a delay in the impeachment trial of Homeland Security Secretary Alejandro Mayorkas. House Republicans had planned to bring the articles of impeachment to the Senate tomorrow, but House Speaker Mike Johnson says that will now happen next week. The Republican-controlled House impeached Mayorkas by a single-vote margin in February, recommending that he be removed from office over his handling of the U.S.-Mexico border.
Wisconsin popular comedian coming to the Wisconsin State Fair.
Acclaimed comedian and Emmy Award winner Charlie Behrens brings his old-fashioned tour to the State Fair main stage August 8th. Behrens tells Wisconsin's Midday News.
My first tour was, you know, about the Midwest, and a lot of this tour is about a guy from the Midwest.
Behrens is in Iowa this week and recently completed tour stops in Southern California.
You're golden here in Wisconsin, but how do these shows go over when you're in L.A.? It's got to be different.
Yeah, I mean, I'm more like silver or bronze out there, you know, maybe like a high-quality lead.
Greg Matzik, WTMJ News.
Tickets go on sale April 12th at 10 a.m.
Former and current Packers players making their way across southern Wisconsin to encourage all of us.
Former DT Mike Daniels was one of them, and at Mesmer High School on Monday, he made an effort to interact with the students as he talked about perseverance. He tells WTMJ.
When you're speaking with kids, you need them to be able to feel comfortable when they're listening to you. Notice there was a lot of chattering, then all of a sudden it was like you could hear a pin drop as I was talking. Guys, I understand you. Guys, I've been where you're at, and I'm not talking down to you like I'm an adult. I'm talking to you like someone who understands. When you give that type of respect, then it's given back.
From Mesmer High School, Julian Johnson, WTMJ News.
The Packers will continue their tour through Saturday.
Time for a WTMJ sports update from the Gruber Law Office's One Call, That's All Sports Desk. After a wild 10-8 loss to the Reds last night, the Brewers will try again tonight in Game 2 in Cincinnati. Coverage begins at 5:05 on WTMJ. The Bucks aim to snap a four-game losing streak tonight against the Eastern Conference-leading Boston Celtics. Hear that game on 94.5 ESPN at 6:30. With four games to play in the regular season, the Bucks are currently one game ahead of both the Magic and the Knicks for second place in the Eastern Conference playoff race.
Setting a limited WTMJ news time, 4:34.
This report sponsored by Pella of Wisconsin. Discover Pella now, pay later at PellaWI.com.
Beautify your entertainment space with Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Hi, this is Gina Della from Pella. Turn your ordinary space into something extraordinary with brand new Pella windows. The luxurious look, sleek design, and custom colors available is guaranteed to give your home the extra pop to entertain and keep you comfortable. At Pella, we see windows differently. We have the highest rated energy efficient products and a complete range of durable, functional, and high quality products that bring out the best of your home. Plus, getting the perfect windows and doors for your home has never been easier. Right now, get 0% interest for up to 36 months or no down payment, no interest, and no payments for up to 18 months if you book before April 30th. That's right, get 0% interest for up to 36 months or no down payment, no interest, and no payments for up to 18 months if you book before April 30th. Take ownership of your living space and make it a place worth living with Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin.
Wisconsin's Afternoon News on WTMJ.
Welcome back to Wisconsin's Afternoon News. Hey, coming up in just a couple of minutes, we talk a lot about exercise, and I feel like we always do it kind of in a broad, nebulous sense, like, you need more exercise. Stay healthy. What exactly does that mean? And how much exercise really do you need to make a difference? Dr. John Raymond, the president and CEO of the Medical College of Wisconsin, will be with us to kind of go inside that topic. He's here in about 10 minutes on WTMJ. Then it's Brewers coverage at 5 o'clock, right after the news. So if you're looking for a late night snack, you've been out drinking, maybe you work third shift, maybe you're a night owl, it's harder and harder to find places to eat out in the middle of the night. The heyday of 24-hour diners and restaurants appears to be over. A couple of stats for you. The number of restaurants offering 24-hour service has fallen 18% in the last 4 years, according to data. So it's fallen 18%. Who's rebounding? Who's actually coming back? Breakfast chains are beginning to rebound. So IHOP, International House of Pancakes, 1,800 locations are back to being open 24 hours a day, at least a couple days a week. Denny's, the other one that was famous for always being open 24 hours. 75% of Denny's locations are open 24 hours again.
People hate on Denny's.
Yeah, they do.
I had a really great Denny's when I was a reporter in Kalamazoo, Michigan.
They used to have great, I used to go there occasionally for breakfast, like their Grand Slam breakfast. It was fine. I mean, you're not going to get like a filet at a Denny's that you're going to love, but it's fine for a sandwich or a breakfast.
I'm sure the grade of what they use wasn't that great, but
right.
Honestly, it was really nice.
And it was good, right?
Yeah.
Waffle House. I've never been to a Waffle House. They're big down south.
Mm-hmm.
All the Waffle House restaurants are back to being open 24 hours. So why are so many other restaurants not open 24 hours anymore? Well, it started with the pandemic. So everybody kind of shut down altogether. Then as they came back, they realized that people weren't out drinking as late is one of the major problems. Bars came back late. And then they also realized that as food costs went up, unless people were out drinking and hanging out late at night, that it just wasn't worth their time to stay open late.
That's the biggest moneymaker is the alcohol. They don't care about your plates.
Nope. They make their money on the alcohol. Mm-hmm. Food costs are up 25%. Liquor costs are up. Wages are up 29%. And so a lot of these places said, well, we're going to cut where almost nobody comes in here anyhow. So they got rid of stuff overnight. So I bring this all up because I'm almost embarrassed to say this, but I've been in Milwaukee for 25 years. And for the very first time, I went to a George Webb. And George Webb, they advertise that they're open for 23 hours and 59 minutes. That's kind of one of their taglines.
I love that.
I don't know what 1 minute they're not open. I couldn't find that. I couldn't find that anywhere online. I actually tried calling a George Webb, the one right near the studio here, and the lady there said, "Honey, we open. Like, we're not closed for 1 minute." So I went to my first George Webb, and they're kind of known for their burgers. Like, if the Brewers win 12 in a row, I think you get free hamburgers, I think, is one of their deals. So I walk into this George Webb, and it's right here on 3rd Street, not far from where we broadcast. I went with a colleague here from work, and he asked me, "Do you have plans for lunch?" I said, "No, I don't have plans for lunch." He said, "Why don't you go out with me for lunch?" I said, "All right, where are we going?" I was thinking we go somewhere nice. He said, "Let's go to George Webb." I said, "George Webb?" He said, "You ever been to George Webb?" And I said, "No, as a matter of fact, I haven't." He said, "Let's go." So we walked down the street, sat down. I just had a cheeseburger and fries and Diet Pepsi, which is weird. Who doesn't have Diet Coke? But it was Diet Pepsi.
Oh, Dr. Raymond was trying to tell you not to do
Dr.
diet.
Dr. Raymond's guest told us last week we shouldn't have diet soda.
Yes.
But it was a rare splurge. I don't have diet soda very often.
All right.
I'm just saying that because Dr. Raymond's sitting in here. And I really don't, Dr. Raymond. And so I had the cheeseburger and the fries, and it was a very pleasant experience. I liked it. The waitress was fun. She was fantastic. She was nice. It's a basic menu. Have you been to a George Webb?
All right. I totally mixed it up with something else. I don't know what I was thinking George Webb was. I totally got it wrong.
Because I asked you during the commercial break, I said, "Hey, have you ever been to a George Webb?" And you said, "Yeah, I think I had the filet."
Yeah.
I was like, "The filet and at George Webb."
Oh, man.
Okay, so you and I are going to go to George Webb.
Okay.
And we're going to go with Arnie here from the station.
Oh, my gosh. He's the best.
Yeah, and he's the one that took me.
I love Arnie.
So then we started talking to the people there about the hours that they're open. And they also have cut back on their hours at several of the George Webb locations for the same reason. Because they say they don't have the foot traffic that they used to have. And they think that the pandemic just changed people's habits. Here's another thing. Research shows that since the pandemic, Americans are eating meals earlier. Restaurant reservations show that for dinner, 10% of all diners eat between 3 o'clock and 5 o'clock for dinner.
That's me. I get really hungry at 3.
Okay, so that's 10%.
My husband wants 6.
We eat dinner at like 8.
I know. Why? So late.
Well, I usually work out after work. And wow. So that has to make it, I don't know, I grew up always eating that late, but we stay up late. I'm also up to like 1 in the morning.
Oh my goodness.
So, but 10% of people are early diners now. That's up, that's doubled since before the pandemic. We're not talking big numbers, but it is double. Went from 5% to 10%. The same survey showed that younger Americans are drinking less. What percentage of Americans do you think claim they don't drink alcohol at all? Like none. Never drink.
Is this a Wisconsin one or national?
National. National. What percentage of adults do you think never drink alcohol?
I would say maybe 10%.
I would have said 20%.
What is it?
38% of Americans say they never drink. Before the pandemic, it was 32% said they never drank. And a couple of decades ago, it was 28%. So interesting. I don't think people would have guessed this. I wouldn't have, that people are drinking less, or less people, I should say, are drinking. And they say that all contributes to the demise of the 24-hour restaurant.
Interesting.
When was the last time you went to a restaurant after bar time? And I use that loosely.
Oh,
I'm not saying you were at a bar, but at 2 o'clock in the morning that you went to a restaurant.
And then the lights come on. I'm thinking of like a nightclub. And then
you start to flash
all
the
of your makeup like came off while you were drinking and you're like, maybe 23. I'm 38 now.
I was trying to think. I don't know the last time I was in a restaurant like that wasn't during normal hours. So we're the fault. It's our fault that these restaurants are struggling. You and I should go to bed at the normal time, set our alarm, go to George Webb's at 2:30 just to help the wait staff because they're not getting enough business.
And drink at like 2 in the morning.
Yeah. No, I'm definitely not in that 28% that's not, that 38% that's not drinking. I'm definitely not in that. No. I mean, Dr. Raymond, I mean, I occasionally drink in moderation, only in moderation. That's the truth, by the way.
It is.
4:43 at WTMJ. Okay, I teased this earlier. We're going to have this discussion. I've been looking forward all day to having this discussion. It's about exercise. We talk in broad terms, I think, sometimes about exercise. Like, you need to exercise. It's good for your health. But we never really dive into what kind of exercise, how much exercise, why it actually matters. We've even had this discussion with Dr. Raymond in the past, but not at the depth that we're going to have it today. So insights into the health benefits of exercise. It's up next with Dr. John Raymond right here on WTMJ.
The Upswing with Jeff Sherman.
So the conversation is going to be fun, informative, and truly full of innovation.
Get to know what's going on in the community and businesses throughout Milwaukee and Wisconsin.
Music already sort of happens in different ways, but what an amazing venue to potentially look at how music can continue to put the and in the experience.
Yeah.
Weekdays from 10 to 11 on WTMJ.
John Mercure here for Griffin Chevrolet in Milwaukee. They've got a spring special going on right now. Griffin will inspect and rotate your tires, check your battery, a complete multi-point inspection, check your heat, change your wiper blades, check that AC, the air filter, all for $179.95. Great service department at the Griffin locations. My car was in the Griffin Ford location in Waukesha not that long ago. Man, they took good care of me. And if you're looking for selection of buying a new vehicle, it's Griffin. 70 new vehicles at Griffin Chevrolet. Ready to deliver. Find fresh selection at Griffin Chevrolet today. For great used trucks and capable SUVs and budget vehicles, see Griffin Chevy in the Metro Auto Mall. Ask about the GM certified models. They started under $20,000. And while you're there, check out the all-new 2024 Chevy Traverse at Griffin Chevrolet. It's got a new body design. It's pretty cool looking. Check out the 2024 Trailblazer at Griffin Chevrolet. 20 to choose from on the lot right now, and your vehicle's worth more. So you want to sell your vehicle? You don't even need to buy anything from them. You don't have to trade anything in. They will buy your vehicle outright and pay you top dollar. Purchase a great pre-owned Chevy today. They've got those as well, $69.95. Great prices, great vehicles, Griffin Chevrolet.
So if you're already in a relationship with an auto service center, that's great. We hope things keep firing on all cylinders.
But if you're not in a relationship, why not book your next date with us at Richlands? The next time you're due for service.
All of our locations are AAA approved and staffed by ASC certified technicians with PhDs in
We Can Fix Anything!
Put that on top of the friendliest, hardest working staff you'll ever meet inside a tire and service center.
And you've got yourself a rock solid date.
The next time you're due for factory scheduled maintenance
or tires, brakes, and suspension service,
book your date at richlands.com.
Or just Google us. But remember, Richlands is spelled with two N's.
And oh yeah, be safe, buckle up, and hey.
Always make sure you have good tread on your tires. I'm Courtney Matchkey with Richlands, and you're due for a date.
Clever.
Richlands Tire and Service, such a refreshing change. Richlands.
Gene Miller here. Springtime, better start thinking about those home improvement projects. Now's the time to call my friends at Hometown Windows and Doors. Update your home's curb appeal and build equity with energy-efficient replacement windows and doors from brands like Pella, Anderson, Marvin, and more. Hometown can also customize your project. They're your local source for wood, vinyl, or fiberglass windows and doors. Stop into their newly remodeled showroom in New Berlin to see the Hometown difference. That's Hometown with an E for your every window and door need. HometownWindows.com.
Traffic is sponsored by CenterPoint. CenterPoint's pontoon and deck boat preseason sale is happening now.
Rev up your summer at CenterPoint's pontoon and deck boat preseason sale happening now. Unbeatable deals from over 10 top-notch boat and motor brands. CenterPoint Pewaukee, Highway 16 and Capitol Drive.
Traffic and weather, let's get you where you need with Debbie Lazaga.
All right, we've got northbound 41 at Mayfair Road with an accident on the left shoulder, so watch out for that. We've also got the other accident on the bypass southbound at Oklahoma Avenue off on the right shoulder. So still a bit backed up as you're making your way from Greenfield Avenue all the way down in through the Hale interchange. Also, keep in mind, Mequon Road still showing that it's closed in both directions right at Cedarburg Road because of an incident. So you'll want to try and stay away from that whole area if you can. I'm Debbie Lazaga with your WTMJ Johnson & Sons Paving Time Saver Traffic.
60 degrees right now in Milwaukee. Tonight will be cloudy with a low of 44 degrees. Tomorrow will be mild. The high will be 62 at the lake and 65 warmer inland. Thursday, rain is likely with a high of 50 degrees. Friday, early showers are likely with a high of 53 degrees. Saturday, you get to see the sun with a high of 60 degrees.
Dr. John Raymond is the president and CEO of the Medical College of Wisconsin, and he is with us live in the studio. Good to see you, Dr. Raymond. Thank you so much for being
here. Thanks, John and Julia.
I love this topic because we're going to discuss exercise, and we're going to do it from the vantage point of new insights about the health benefits of exercise and really kind of dive into this. And I'm so glad that you're here. Let's start with this. We know that people should check with their doctor before starting a new exercise routine. That's important. But are there simple ways to test your own level of fitness to kind of just do this on your own?
Yeah, there are two that I'd like to talk about. The first is very simple. It's a test of cardiovascular fitness, and it's how many flights of stairs you can go up without getting winded. The more stairs you can ascend, the better off that you're going to be. And if you're trying to improve your cardiovascular fitness, you can add a step or two every day and really improve your overall health. Again, though, remember, you need to talk to your doctor first. A more complicated, more difficult overall fitness test is called the sit-stand-floor test. It's a simple but challenging exercise, so it requires a person from a standing position to sit on the floor and then to stand up without using hands or arms. It also docks you points if you have to use your knees, your elbows, your forearms to get up. So perfect form, you don't use anything other than your feet to stand all the way up. It's a perfect score of 10. If you have to use a hand or a knee or an elbow, you take a point off for each one. So the reason we're talking about this is it is correlated with long-term survival. So you get an 8 or above score, then you have at least a normal survival. When your score is lower than that, then you actually can take as many as 6 years off your predicted lifespan.
Wow.
Now, we do believe that if you take that seriously and try to improve your score, you probably live longer.
Because, okay, that was my follow-up question. So say you score a 7. If you make the effort to, I'm going to lose weight, I'm going to get in better shape, I'm going to get into exercise, and you do the exercise, this drill again, a year from then, and now you're at a 9 instead of a 7, you've just really helped yourself, right?
You're probably going to live longer. The beauty of that test is it tests your strength, your flexibility, and your balance. All those things are very important for your long-term fitness and longevity.
Hmm. Planking, too, for a minute. That is really difficult. It's not as easy as it looks. Older adults are also having trouble getting motivated to exercise. What's the research behind that to get them motivated?
Yeah, there's some really interesting research that basically suggests that self-motivation is good, but if you talk about your exercise regime to someone else, that you're actually more compliant. And there's a recent study that shows that you can improve your overall compliance by about 25 minutes per day. If you just talk to somebody, about your exercise regimen. So there's a social aspect of exercise that doesn't even require somebody else to be in the same room with you. Just talking about it can help.
We are such social butterflies.
That's so true. Mm-hmm. I can totally relate to that. You're absolutely right about that. So we've talked a lot in different segments and shows about the optimal type and amount of exercise. How about some basic foundational guidance when we talk about types and amount of exercise?
Yeah, thank you. Sure. Any exercise is better than none. So we'll start there. And just remind people, if you're not exercising now, talk to your doctor before you start a program. And that's really important. But the recommendations are that we get in 20 to 30 minutes per day, or about 150 minutes per week, of moderate aerobic exercise. A brisk walk would be something in that range, or 75 minutes per week of a more vigorous exercise, running, weightlifting, strenuous activity. Aerobic exercises like walking, jogging, or bicycling generally are the ones that we recommend, but strength, flexibility, and balance also matter. So one goal that people talk about all the time is to try to get 10,000 steps in per day. That's really not feasible for most people. That's an hour of walking. So we do get health benefits from 5,000 steps per day. So that would be a good goal. And there is new research that shows that different types of exercise might be better for different conditions. Your heart, your weight, blood pressure, diabetes management.
Yeah. I got 36,000 steps when I was a reporter one day. I was like, whoa.
Whoa, that's constant.
I'm traveling.
Walking. That's a lot.
Not so much anymore. So for someone with high blood pressure, what are some good exercises? I'm thinking about my friend who, when she was like a marathon runner, she had like 35 beats a minute. I was like, what?
Yeah. Well, you know, we always think about running, jogging, walking, or bicycling to reduce our blood pressure. And those types of aerobic exercises do reduce your blood pressure on average by about 4 to 6 millimeters of mercury. But there's new evidence that suggests that the best exercises to lower blood pressure are planks, which you talked about earlier, or wall squats. So those would be the kind of exercises that if you're really serious about lowering your blood pressure, you should focus on planks or wall squats.
What about the best type of exercise for losing weight?
Yeah, that's really a good question. You know, again, we thought 10,000 steps, you're going to lose weight. It's not that easy. Recent studies show that you need an average of 14,500 steps per day.
Wow.
To lose weight. So weight is probably the most difficult condition to treat with exercise. Now, if you're really serious, remember that you might try taking flights of stairs. We talked about on the show earlier, 5 flights of stairs per day up and down gives you the same health benefits as 5,000 steps. And if you're in pretty good shape, you can do that a lot more quickly if time
That's
management
amazing.
Is an issue.
I'm going to be going up and down our steps a lot more.
We got
more.
A lot of them here in the building.
It sounds hard. Some of those steps gets up maybe 14,000. Are there any medications that can make our exercise more efficient so we can have better results?
Yeah, believe it or not, there's actually quite a lot of research ongoing about whether we can reproduce the benefits of exercise or a good diet simply by taking a pill or a supplement. And so these pills would mimic the physiological effects of exercise or eating responsibly. And they're so-called have your cake and eat it too drugs. Believe it or not, some of those are in development, mostly in mice. So there are some benefits. There's a drug that basically causes mice to bulk up so that they become buff with very little exercise.
Oh, that's so cute.
There's a couch potato pill that can make mice that aren't really doing much have good physical fitness. And then there are other drugs that mimic the effect of a good diet. It's possible that within 4 to 5 years, we might actually see these on the market.
Wow.
Because some of them are going into clinical trials. So there's promise in the have your cake and eat it too drugs, maybe right along in 4 or 5 years.
Oh, that's fascinating.
We're going to be buff, John.
Just sitting here in this chair. All right. Good news of the week, Dr. Raymond.
Yeah. The good news of the week is this week is National Library Week. And there was a really cool quote that one of my colleagues gave me by Michael Embry. And it's, I don't have to look far to find treasures. I discover them every day, each time I visit a library. So visit your library.
Yeah. I like that.
Absolutely.
That's fantastic.
There's so much there, too. It's not,
yeah.
It's so much learning that you can do there.
Yeah, my first job was in the library. I have a real soft spot for libraries. That's a great quote, Dr. Raymond. Thank you so much. Dr. John Raymond is a professor of medicine and the president and CEO of the Medical College of Wisconsin. We appreciate you always taking the time for us, Dr. Raymond. Thanks,
John and Julia.
Thank you.
It is 4:56 at WTMJ. Here's Sean Ryan at the Milwaukee Business Journal.
Epic Systems' eclectic office campus in Verona is about to get more interesting. The city approved new buildings with architecture echoing Lord of the Rings, the Harry Potter books, and Wizard of Oz. Arizona-based Pickleball Kingdom is not moving into Ruby Isle and Brookfield for its much-anticipated first Wisconsin location. The company had considered moving into the former Pick and Save store space, but the plan became cost-prohibitive. Paloma Taco opens its Bayview restaurant on Kinnickinnick Avenue on April 18th. This is the second Paloma restaurant for owner Patty Ford, who opened on North Avenue about 4 years ago. This is Sean Ryan with MilwaukeeBusinessJournal.com on News Radio WTMJ.
WTMJ, W277CV, and WKTI HD2 Milwaukee from the Annex Wealth Management Studios. This is News Radio WTMJ, a Good Karma brand station.
Business headlines sponsored by the Pfister Hotel. Make your reservations today. Visit thepfisterhotel.com.
For over 130 years, the Pfister Hotel in downtown Milwaukee has been delighting guests with impeccable service and luxurious accommodations. Celebrate your next special occasion with a stay at the Pfister. Enjoy fine dining at its acclaimed restaurants and pamper yourself with a service from the Well Spa and Salon. Experience the hotel's afternoon tea program or take in live music with the best views of the city from Blue, the 23rd floor cocktail lounge. There's always a reason to celebrate with the Pfister Hotel. Make your reservations today at thepfisterhotel.com.
John Mercure here for Azura Memory Care and Assisted Living. It's about compassion and empathy at Azura. They're going to take care of your loved one like they take care of their own family. That's how they roll. I know. I've been in their places. And you know what? Where you choose to put someone you love is a critical decision. I want compassion. I want empathy. At Azura, it's kindness at the core. Memory care, dementia, Alzheimer's, they specialize in memory issues. 14 locations in our state, 4 in Milwaukee. It's Azura. Wisconsin-based and family-owned, it's Azura.
Download the free Upside app to earn real cash back every time you buy gas. Use promo code GIFT for an extra 25 cents per gallon on your first fill-up. That's promo code GIFT.
Get your rock-solid guaranteed pre-approval to buy at accunet.com.
WTMJ's Vince Vitrano for Orthopedic Associates of Wisconsin. Injuries happen, but you don't have to play in pain or stay on the sidelines. Whether it's your kids dealing with a sports injury, college athletes, or the rest of us weekend warriors, the experts at Orthopedic Associates of Wisconsin will quickly diagnose your problem, lay out a treatment plan that works for you, and get you back in the game. They fixed my knee. My mother-in-law is back on the dance floor with a new hip. These are the experts you can trust. Visit orthowisconsin.com.
Good Karma Brands is proud to be an equal opportunity employer. Our policy is to provide equal opportunity employment, development, and advancement to all current and potential teammates. If you are an organization that maintains a job bank, provides employment information, or gives job referrals, you may request to be placed on the station's mailing list for future career opportunities. To learn more about careers at Good Karma Brands, please email careers@goodkarmabrands.com.
Fleet Farm's got everything you need for everyday life. Brands from Carhartt to Milwaukee to Purina to Goodyear to Rapala to Levi's and a whole lot more. In-store or online, check out all the brands Fleet Farm carries to help make your everyday life better.
Find furniture for life from Ken Michaels Furniture in Brookfield, Greenfield, or downtown Milwaukee.
1-0, high fly ball, right center field. Racing back is Fairchild. Back is Thompson at the wall. He reaches up, and it is gone. Bryce Terang.
The Brewers continue their series against the Reds in Cincinnati. Our coverage of the series continues tonight at 5:05 on your home of the Milwaukee Brewers. News Radio 620, WTMJ, Milwaukee.
It's 5:01. I'm John Mercure. Your top story, sentencing from Michigan high school shooting.
I'm Julia Fellow. A deadly house fire in Milwaukee.
Debbie Lozaga, 41 northbound at Mayfair Road on the left shoulder. Still have an accident up on the board there. We've got delays along southbound 43 from before Hampton Avenue down past Keefe. Slow northbound right out of the Marquette all the way up to Keefe. East and westbound on 94 also backed up between the zoo and the stadium interchange in either direction. I'm Debbie Lozaga with your WTMJ Johnson & Sons Paving Time Saver Traffic.
Tonight, clear skies, a low of 43. Tomorrow, sunny and mild, a good one on tap. A high of 67 inland, a little cooler along the lake. From the WTMJ Breaking News Center, the parents of a convicted Michigan high school shooter who killed four of his classmates in 2021 have both been sentenced to prison for the actions of their son. Jennifer and James Crumbly have each been sentenced to at least 10 years in prison for failing to take steps that could have prevented the killing of four students in 2021.
A father remembers his six-year-old son who died in a fire on 36 and War Avenue last week.
TMJ4 reports Rashawn Wilson III was pronounced dead at the hospital 4 days after a late-night house fire on April 2nd. TMJ4's Marion McCarr shares what his heartbroken father, Rashawn Wilson II, said in a text.
My son is greatly missed and my family is broken behind the loss of my special boy, and all my family want is the truth.
A neighbor in the area says,
"Stunned, super shocked, super sad. Like, it's, to me, that's so tragic that that happened to him. Like I said, it seemed like he didn't even get a chance."
Julian Johnson, WTMJ News.
Investigators have not yet released the cause of this fire.
Caledonia Police and the Wisconsin State Patrol investigating a crash that killed a man from West Allis. It happened in Caledonia this morning. The driver of the PT Cruiser, an 18-year-old woman from Racine, she remained on scene for the investigation.
Governor Evers putting pen to paper on the Prince Act.
With the governor's signature today, the Prince Act becomes the Purple Alert. State Senator LaTanya Johnson was critical in the implementation of the act and tells WTMJ,
"We were cognitive of making sure that this alert applied to children 10 and under and then 18 and under for children with physical or cognitive disabilities that would prevent them from returning home safely."
Governor Evers added he expects the alert to be implemented within the coming weeks. In Milwaukee, Adam Roberts, WTMJ News.
Time for a WTMJ sports update from the Gruber Law Office's One Call, That's All Sports Dex. Bucks aim to snap a four-game losing streak against the Celtics tonight. That's on ESPN. And Brewers in action straight ahead right here on WTMJ. Tough loss last night. Coverage begins up next on WTMJ.
Suit up for the $800,000 Sports Car Series at Pop.